Yo, 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 Murnawana. We're 1 minute late, but TMZ's on the air.
Yo, 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 Goodwin. It's hour and 20 pre-show. If people were watching in the, wondering where we were the last, usually we do 20 minutes of pre-show warm-up, so I get warmed up a bit. And you've been on the phone for the last hour, 20 minutes, trying to get this supercomputer.
Oh?
Yeah, we got a supercomputer, so super powerful that we're over there. Chris was on the phone with the Tac-Man.
Look how clear the TVs are. Look over at the TV.
Whoa.
That's a lot better than before, eh, when you couldn't read it?
Dude, we got some super kick-ass power back there. We'll be taking as many Skype calls as we can, we hope, because of the machinery. I'm in a lot of fibromyalgia pain, and I can feel that brain. Whoa, Smash almost wrecked a bit of the set, but she's okay.
Where's Jay Danger?
I don't know where Danger is tonight, but my phone's been off, so maybe he'd message me. It's that last few weeks of school where if you're in any school assignment that requires production, where you're doing, like, photography, and you have to hand in a bunch of photography assignments.
I have 3 assignments. I'm here.
Well, then.
Shame.
Everyone in chat says your butt on bud cam looks a little yellow, but maybe it's the lighting they're debating.
I think it's competing with the light from outside.
It is, you know.
Not a yellow bud.
Not yellow.
I have a big nug for nug swap as well.
Yep. Smash brought out some big cannons tonight. So, butt swap at 8:20 tonight. That's your chance to trade your marijuana for someone else's marijuana. We got that on the show. We have UK Cannabis Factory Bust of the Week. That'll be out there. You can see I'm clearly leaning sideways because Matt's in pain. We have Tamara Smash, myself. We have a big announcement out of Vancouver, B.C. regarding the John Conroy case. That's the John Conroy case. We'll get to that in a second. I just want to get a vapor bag going. We're going to take your Skype callers. If you are in Vancouver, we want to hear from you. We also will be reading the tweets from CTV on that, and that has kept us perfectly informed. Grinder?
No, the chamber. I was going to fill it for you.
Are we going to have Conroy on?
No Conroy.
No? Maybe we'll just cold call him.
You can, geez, once we get my phone fired up, I believe I have his cell number.
Right.
Someone put this, like, 10-foot vapor bag up here. Very suggestive.
I haven't started up Skype yet for those that in the chat that want to get on, but I'm going to start it up soon.
I also have Jason Wilcox said he'd try and Skype. He said he had Skype. I sent him all the details on Facebook. I sent a bunch of people out there. Thankfully, we have CTV was doing live tweeting all day. They rocked the Twitter sphere today with CTV reporting heavily. Didn't realize how big it was.
Reporting.
The case. John Conroy's in court, in case you know, seeking an injunction and has launched a constitutional challenge against the MMPR, which is the brand, is on marijuana.
That's crazy.
Yeah, and if you ask them, well, how much do you spend going after child pervs? I guarantee you that's not as much as the drug budget. How much are you spending on the rape unit? I guarantee it's not as much as the drug budget. The homicide unit, the dogs and horses get more fucking money than sexual assault people. This is crazy. And you got a guy making several hundred thousand dollars a year saying, I'm looking forward to getting the list April 30th. Son, you pissed me fucking off again, and we're gonna operate Operation Mail Out. I am committed to sending out letters to Health Canada with fake addresses, and I am going to flood those fuckers with as many letters as I can afford. Buy a book of 25 stamps, and if you need addresses for the return address, we'll get you Rob Ford's donor list that has a name, an address, and a postal code on it.
By the way, all members...
Fuck these fuckers.
All members of Parliament are postage free.
Yeah, well, we're going to jam up the Health Canada snitch line. They want people to snitch on themselves, Goodwin. That's what they're doing.
Right.
Incriminate yourself.
Incriminate yourself. So if you don't do it, you might be on a list. And if you do it, you're definitely on a list. So what if a whole bunch of people who aren't doing it just started sending letters to them? Yeah, opened like 50 of these today, buddy.
Now, if someone were to come and knock on your door and ask to see your apartment, you just say no and close the door, right?
No and close the door. Some man shows up with Don't even open your door.
There's a clipboard? Forget it.
If you see police at your door, do not open it. Speak through the door. Do not open your door to the police. Speak through the door.
Wow.
Right.
You opening always, the door.
Don't open it.
Never
no.
open it.
Never
opening
open
the door counts as welcome them in.
They're like vampires. You never open a door to a vampire. You don't open the door to the police.
Is this Lost Boys? I know. I'm just asking. Like,
100%. Think of the Lost Boys. Think of the Lost Boys. That's
if they
the
can't hear you very clearly or you can't hear them, just tell
find
them.
Find a window.
Have your supervisor call me.
Yep.
Because that's the thing. As soon as you open the door, all the police have to say is like, I smell marijuana. And bam, in they go.
Yeah, so speak through the door, growers. Be prepared. They're coming.
I don't understand. Like, opening your door is not the same thing as inviting someone in.
It is, though, to them.
Wow. They're
like vampires. Keep that door
closed. How coercive. Fucking
keep
weird.
The door closed. Speak through the door. They hate that. They 100% hate that. I'm like not letting the cop in. So don't open your door to the man. Think like the Lost Boys. So, we're going to try and organize Operation Mail Out, where I would encourage you all to send letters to Health Canada and simply rat out anonymous people who have no program, they've never been in the program whatsoever, just to tie up the guy who's got to take the letter opener and check the database. These letters could take up some time.
And then
on
he's like, fuck another one.
Exactly, fuck another one. You know, you get someone doing that every day and they get 100 fucks to everyone that they catch, the odds start looking great on our side. Like, if you're going to go that low, like Health Canada, I thought you were going to play like somewhat like, okay, I'm okay. And then you issue a press release on a Friday afternoon saying you're going to round up MedPod people. Go fuck yourselves. We will fight you back. So buy yourself a book of stamps. Get yourself some envelopes, print off that form, and start sending them in. Now, if you're looking for names and addresses, type in Toronto Election 2010 Financial Disclosure. You're going to get a list.
All right.
Go to Rob Ford. He has 192 pages.
Holy shit.
Of people's names and addresses and how much money they gave. So just pick someone who gave $2,500 to Rob Ford, just put their name on the return address, and just drop those in the mailbox. You're only hurting some dick.
A mail bomb. A mail bomb on the Health Canada.
Yeah, it's a total filibuster, and I think people can do it. I would like to see people get behind it. You know, even if you send 10 letters out, like just one book of stamps.
Yeah.
Makes a difference. So I never thought they'd go this low.
And it's easy activism.
Easy activism.
By the way, from our wedding even, like 2 years ago, I still have like an envelope of probably hundreds of stamps worth, I don't know how much money, but we got lots, like rolls
awesome.
And packs. And so if anybody, I'm actually going to donate like $100 in stamps to anybody who wants to do this.
I'll get on that then.
I'm in on this because I was prepared to think how I was just, you know. Like
maybe we have another improv craft day.
Yep. Improv crafts at the lounge day, because really it is, and we got a bit of time to organize ourselves. Like I never thought they'd do this. Rat yourself out. Write us a letter.
But you can't complain about just someone asking you to rat yourself out, though. I have to make an argument that's unethical and coercive and against your liberty.
Oh, there's all that. I'm just at the very basic argument at the very lowest. Like, if you're prepared to hit below the belt, motherfucker, I'm the motherfucking guy who will hit you so low below the belt. I don't even know where I'm going with that.
That expression really doesn't do it justice either. It's far worse.
It's far worse. It's true.
It's like he jerseyed you and tranquilized you and then started punching you and then a bunch of other things. Then called your mother and sent her a picture of it.
Yeah. They're rounding up fucking potheads. The most vulnerable ones. So, we got that going on. We're going to try and get the Skype going. As I said, Conroy's in court fighting for MedPot people. And I've been just on the sidelines on this, so this is good for me. It wasn't until they sent that. I'm like, man, you're just picking on people now, Smash.
Yeah.
They didn't have to. I mean, it's one thing to take away the grows. Okay, sure, you got people who are prepared to fight. But man, a press release on a Friday afternoon. Fucking pissed. So, I know people are interested. Oh man, I don't know how this thing turns on. We got Twitter. My phone. Oh, this has got to. I got to get the device passcode on that.
Do you need a new phone?
No. This is
someone else's phone.
Gidwin's phone. I got to get the passcode. My phone's charging. Because we're trying to get. Didn't want to be seeking bail that day with that attorney.
Nope.
So we got a whole bunch of the CTV. Do we have it pulled up there? This thing's Aaron. Appreciate that. Melanie Nagy. So from Melanie Nagy, we learned that it'll be by Friday online. Check Conroy's site and all that. So we're going to start, I guess, at the beginning, right, Goodwin?
It's probably a good logical place to start.
She's got, like, hours and hours of tweets, though, because all of a sudden CTV is probably like, your Twitter is exploding.
Yeah, go through them.
Or a couple from the beginning.
We'll start at this 5 hours ago. We might as well start here. Lawyer Tanya Grace says, this is about how many people will suffer loss of enjoyment of life, .. as most won't be able to afford marijuana under the new system. So this is Conroy's team. She also says, this is about a new regime unnecessarily upsetting the established apple cart. Also being argued right now, the amount of funds dedicated and personal growers have invested in their growing systems. What happens to that? So those are the openers. And then the judge shoots and says, again, judge again reminds lawyers that he's read all the material. That means you got to start telling me something new that I haven't thought of. Just don't read what you wrote, so to speak, in the letters to me. Lawyer tells judge that the new rules put patients back to square one when the court has already sanctioned the right to produce. I don't know what she was smoking there. Goodwin, is that correct?
What did it say again?
Say that again.
Lawyer tells judge that the new rules, quote, put patients back to square one when the court has already sanctioned the right to produce.
Yeah?
No. Where's the citation on that?
Well, I've only ever been saying that there's precedent for protection for personal growing in the court, so I don't know. I'm not sure.
Parker was the right to possess. And, of course, the Ontario court says you have no rights to either. Obviously. Lawyers exploring notion of weighing public safety against patients' right to medicine. She says new rules leave patients out on a limb. Lawyer says people should be allowed to continue what they're doing until all issues are dealt with.
That's a good idea.
Here we go. Health Canada now being hammered for info released Friday about patients, growers needing to submit letters stating they trashed their pot. That's what we were ranting about. Yeah. The notice went out that not only will medical marijuana be destroyed, but if it wasn't, police would be notified.
Wow.
Okay, so we have a Toronto Police Service bust 33 fucking grow ops in 2011. What? Are you guys feeling kind of incompetent over there, Mr. Inspector Franks? So, co-counsel rest, court is on break. And that was Tanya Grace.
Sorry. I think people approaching the government, too.
Will be harm done to patients in time it would take for case to go trial. Oh, lawyers for the government say they don't think it's been proven there'll be harm done to patients in time it would take for case to go to trial, which is the Conroy case. They also say they don't think there is enough evidence that medicinal marijuana will become unaffordable. And that's where they're asking patients, designated growers, to give commercial growers a chance to get production off the ground.
That's fair.
Lawyer also tells the judge that it's their position that there is no economic right to low-cost medicine. So that's the point that we wanted to harp on, is that We think the same thing. It's that it says the lawyer, which is the government, tells the judge that there is no that tells the government that there's a position that there is no economic right to low cost medicine. So the courts, the government of Canada is saying you don't have a right to cheap medication.
That's true.
Which we knew they were going to argue. We knew that that's a given. So then the lawyer from Health Canada goes through the affidavit of Mr. Allard. He's the main plaintiff. And then the lawyer suggests that Allard can't afford medical marijuana because he owns his own home with no mortgage, i.e. he's paid the mortgage off and has an income. So that's something the judge has to actually weigh. Guy owns a home versus you got shit. Because the judge could be like, well, he could sell his home to buy medical marijuana and stuff. Hate to break it to you. The lawyer's saying you have no right to low-cost medicine.
Well, it is true in the eyes of the court. Like, as a right is defined by the courts, means you have to have access, and then if you can't have it, then the government has to give it to you.
Yeah. So lawyer says the plaintiffs have not met the burden of irreparable harm. Here it says the plaintiff's evidence based around the issue of harm cannot be based on unfounded speculation. Typical attacks. Lawyer gives the court the latest number of approved licensed producer. The current number is at 11. So you'll probably say something like, Your Honor, it's grown 11 times since the old program. We've increased supply by 11 times. So to the court, that's what they have to hang on. I hate to break it to people. Judge asking government lawyer about economics of scale. This is interesting. Judge says he sees little evidence that large for-profit producers will be motivated to produce a wide variety of strains for patients. Huh.
That one was weird to me, that for some reason that they think that large producers won't be motivated to have a large variety?
That's what the judge seems to think.
Hmm.
I don't know. I think he's must have been smoking some BC Bud that day. Out on the break there. Here, this is funny. Judge says he doesn't see how LPs would see unique strains as profitable, and therefore how will the government accommodate patients?
Wow.
Here's the answer, though, that people were now going to groan about in the chat, and something I pointed out. Lawyer, which is the Crown. Crown responding to his questions. Crown suggests that there is not ample evidence that unique strains are any better. True. There is no ample evidence of strain data. There's no expert. There's no expert on strains. In fact, if you look at some of the latest data that says this is purple kush, and you chances are you look at it 100 times under the genomes of it, like the what it is, all of it will be different. And they've done that in dispensaries in California where they're like, all this is different, but it's all labeled the same. Fascinating.
How many phenotypes do you get from a plant?
Well, from a plant?
Like in a line of genetics, so like...
Well,
how many different expressions of one set of genetics can a plant have?
Well, the plant itself could have hundreds. But, you know, in a pack of seeds, you could get, like, three different kinds of plants in a pack of 10.
Huh.
And the lawyer is standing on his ground. He thinks that the case should be outright dismissed. Like, just dismiss it. Lawyer for the government does say that an exemption will compromise the new fledgling commercial medical marijuana system.
True.
That's fascinating because I don't think that's true.
I think you meant that people get angry.
I think a lot of those commercial suppliers can live quite happily without people growing. I mean, there's a whole new marketplace opening up for them. There's all new access. These guys are, like, working on the paperwork and making it better and better to get the applications because they want the market. They're going to doctors. So I can't see. I really didn't think you needed to kick personal production in the head. I think people should have been able to personally produce or buy from the licensed producer. I don't think the licensed producers really need that market. I think it's a mistake for the lawyer to say it's going to hurt people. I mean, these guys are... They have deep pockets, I think it's the word I'd like to say.
And not all patients want to deal with a grow.
Exactly.
So.
So, you didn't want to grow it yourself, you'd go to an LP, because I think a lot of people would want to buy it from, you know, they shouldn't have to interact with the cannabis culture to find the designated grower.
Getting it mailed to the house just sounds excellent.
Yeah. Right, so... That's the Conroy case. Sometime before Friday, we'll have the announcement of whether or not he wins. Check out Cannabis Culture, I guess, when Jeremiah gets back, and they'll do a story on it. I don't know. You found everything out right there from CTV. From her tweets. It looks like a fascinating day in court.
Covered that very well.
Yeah, she covered it very, very well. What do you think, Goodwin?
Yeah, the CTV lady was... popular this afternoon.
I thought she
did. How many followings and whatnot?
I don't know.
I followed her like, I don't know, mid-afternoon, and she followed me back like an hour later, so.
Wasn't there like numbers generated?
Yeah, I could click on it.
No.
But she tweeted up a storm today.
That's exciting.
I wonder what the ruling's going to be Friday.
Well, by Friday, so any, it could be come out tomorrow. What do you think?
I've been predicting he's going to lose. Although I'm obviously optimistic and I would hope that he wins, but I'm predicting a loss.
Here's what I predict.
And I mean, I predict a loss on both ends.
Well, you know. I think he grants the trial and not the injunction. Judges are like that when it comes to these things.
Give you a little bit, but not enough.
Yeah,
I say he's gonna dismiss the trial, dismiss the injunction, and although I think he might award costs and go that route.
I'm awful today.
Smash dropped the canister up here, but
just we'll get it. We can get it for you even.
Thanks. And we're both pretty sicky today. Fuck, my fibro's acting up like a
fucking
bitch.
Up all the pot today.
Yeah, that's all right. How are you feeling today?
All right, actually.
Really? My fucking fibro's killing me.
I had that awful presentation, but it went really well, actually, and people found it funny. So.
Was that the presentation? So after 420 swap, after Bud swapped it at, geez, Smash. Fuck. And you lost half the volcano piece.
Man, just couch lock me or something.
I don't know what happened. Aaron's looking for
it. Oh, I have it attached still.
We have one piece, but not the other piece, though, hon. Aaron's looking down there.
Wasn't
stage
this
man.
The piece that she would be looking for? Because I had it.
I don't know. Oh, there's another piece. This is like the Kennedy assassination up here. And there's a grinder. That we lost the grinder, too. We found the grinder under
the
couch.
That wasn't me.
It's like the Kennedy assassination with bullet shards everywhere. Fucking crazy. I wish John Conroy the best of luck. I really think... every time people go up against the man, I think they, you know, they should win. And I don't know, I heard 50-50 in front of the right judge, according to a constitutional expert I know, so.
And what did the judge say about him?
Well, I think they're reading his affid. Who was the professor in that affid? I can only think that they got an affidavit from Alan Young.
Right. The judge said, or the... lady from CTV tweeted that the judge said that a submission by a professor is not acceptable.
No, he didn't.
Or something like that.
No, he said we don't have to wait on it. We can accept.
No, but we don't have to put any weight on it. Right.
Oh, right.
It's not
that's
an expert
weight.
Witness.
She spelt the word rate wrong. That's what happened. She spelt the word weight wrong because I thought, what do you mean weight? Oh, weight as in the value of the document.
Right. The judge said it has no weight. Value.
Wow. Which is weird, because when Kurt Tusaw testified for me, that was the best I could get in terms of like, hey, tell them how shitty the program is. In behind closed doors, and they're like, oh, okay, yeah.
But there is no marijuana expert witness.
There are a couple.
Internationally or nationally?
Canadian, too.
Oh, wow.
Well.
Where are they?
Well, they tried to put an affidavit from a professor, and they don't give the name. And Chris and I want to guess that it's Alan Young, but we're not sure.
No, like the courts have to acknowledge you as an expert witness.
You got to go through a couple steps first. You can't just like, hey, here's an affidavit. You actually have to go to court, present a resume. You have to say, like, I graduated from blah, blah, blah. I'm an expert in my field because... Well, you just have to leave your credentials, like your resume. You say things like, I gave a talk to the government. I'm telling you, it's like a bullet went right to the head.
Crazy, crazy day.
It is, because I need more cannabinoid. But we wish him the best. We really do. Good luck out there, and we'll find out in the next couple days.
How's Russ's argument going?
I don't know, but he's not dead yet.
That's good.
That's going to be part of the show now. Russell Barth is not dead. And, you know.
Is that something he's promoting?
No, it's something we're going to promote for the show.
I heard you have a death clock.
I have the death clock. I didn't want to go that far on him. He's pretty stressed by the whole thing. So every week we report whether or not our former Ottawa bureau chief, Russell Barth, is alive or dead.
Don't make him paranoid. He has post-traumatic stress disorder.
I'm smiling. We care about him.
He's nice.
He's nice in a curmudgeon way, right? He's cool. He's a curmudgeon. If anybody knows, I'm running for mayor of Toronto. That's right, mayor of Toronto. I'm pretty serious about this thing.
Yep.
Except on Tuesday nights when I get my unserious side on.
You mean now. So what's the next step? What do you have to do now, or what are you working on?
Well, here's what's going on. Thursday night, we were out, and we held a forum at a building we canvassed, and we met people, we fed them, and we talked about issues in their community, including disability issues. Excuse me. The building is wheelchair accessible and whatnot, so it's a pretty cool building.
Excellent.
Yeah, so that was a fun canvas. Biggest news is that candidate David Sadnaki has, we challenged him late last week on the show last week on Monday, in part of the show is, we challenged the David Sadnaki out of Scarborough, who's running for mayor.
Yeah.
To a geek debate challenge.
Yes.
If you recall, we wanted to know, you know, I would debate him whether or not we should build the Death Star, who is the best Doctor Who. The Death Star would be a pretty good idea. I could argue Death Star, mayor of Toronto, either way. Be a boom for our economy. Be good for 3D printing and aeronautics.
Be good for 3D printing. You want a 3D printed and assembled Death Star in Toronto?
Well, parts of. Parts? Yeah, see? Someone's over there. There we go, yeah. Plus, we'd have it in geosynchronous orbit over the city. Be great for negotiating trade deals. Especially if our theme song was like, dun, dun, dun.
Who's like Toronto making trade deals with? Like Hamilton?
No, international, like on missions to Chicago and all that.
We're going to take out Chicago.
It's a Death Star. You can take out a lot of things.
Thank you,
Aaron. It's a Death Star. You imagine negotiating with Queen's Park for the subway system? Yeah, I got my laser beam pointed right at you, Kathleen Wynne's house. Make a big crater.
You should do what I want.
Yeah. Come join me on my Death Star. So those were things, those were topics. Who would win in a fight, Batman versus Superman?
Someone said Superman down front. I want to say Superman, but I always stay out of this argument.
Batman, if you know.
Because everyone likes Batman.
Batman's way better than Superman, but he picked fire. It looked like Sadnaki was going to go with Batman. I'd have to debate Superman, and Sanaki's like, I got five kinds of kryptonite. Fuck. Nobody can beat almost five kinds of kryptonite. You know it's in there. You know it is. It's in the utility belt somewhere. You know. 100%.
So, can't you just strip Batman of his technology?
Well, then, you'd have to figure out as Superman how to do that. You'd be like, I strip Batman of all his technology with my laser vision.
Instead of, got kryptonite close to him.
You know, it brings up also the debate where, So, also, best Doctor Who. Who is the best Doctor in the Doctor Who series? Good arguments. And so, we got a tweet on Monday from Sanaki's team that said, Seed Geek debate to you.
Wait, he watches the show or you invited him?
He got it, yeah, he heard it.
Oh, wow.
So we got a tweet saying David Sunaki in at 2% in the polls in the Toronto municipal election for mayor has ceded to me in terms of knowledge of geekery and fandom. So here you have it. If you have a PS, if you play video games, you cosplay, you watch the Space Network, you like comic books,
sci-fi,
any of that, I'm your candidate in the Toronto municipal election.
He understands you.
Yeah. I'm your vote. He ceded to me. He was like, I can't face you in a geek debate. I will lose. That's right, buddy. You will lose. But I encourage you to check out Sanaki. He seems like a fun guy. Currently rocking just ahead of me in the Toronto polls. He's rocking 2%. He's just ahead of me. And you can find him. He does a lot of Reddit.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, he's always doing those Reddit chats. And one of the questions someone asked was, who is your favorite member of Wu-Tang Clan, and why is it Reza? And so Sanaki's response was great. His response was great. I had to Google Wu-Tang Clan and a Reza. And his response was, so he said that, and he's like, I respect your decision if you like Reza. I respect that. So he's all doing the Reddit debate, the Reddit discussions. There's the Sanaki. He's out there doing the Reddit.
That's very good. Reaches I hope he a lot of could, people.
You know, he's rocking low in the pool. Someone suggested that there's a song by Drake that's about him, Working My Way Up or something. I don't know. I don't listen to that guy. Hate to break it to people.
He's on the Snoop Dogg list.
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah. Drake's a whiny bitch. That's what I hear.
35,000.
Yeah. The Drake. So that's municipal election update. Olivia Chow's in the running. Her campaign is called Chow Time.
That's clever.
All I can think is a little chow chow dog. I don't know if that's offensive or not, but I think if you say it's chow time.
You're like, chow time, this really adorable dog comes and hangs out with you. I think that's a good time.
It's a pretty good time. And the funny thing is, I see the Ford clan using the words chow time more than she's ever done. I just see it.
Sing.
I just see them come for chow. Chow time, Robbie.
Maybe that's why she did it. It's clever advertising. So he's at some buffet and he's like, it's chow time.
Poor guy.
It's a plug for her.
I look forward to hanging out with Rob Ford in November. Welcome to the show. Be great to have him just as he becomes a has-been celebrity. You know, milk him for that last little bit of celebrityism. when you know they're on the down low, they just made a porn tape, right? Right downhill.
Especially if it was Toronto porn, and then.
I got an email from the Aqua Lounge asking my position on sex lounges and sex work. My response was, have you seen my webcast? And then I politely was like, I know Carly Montana and Alex Voodoo, and they're friends of mine, and you can be assured that not only do I support it, but I'll cut a video for me running for mayor in your lounge.
Yeah, you have dinner with his mom occasionally.
Yeah, I'll wear a towel in there and make a mayor campaign video in the Aqua Lounge if Aqua Lounge is we would support that.
Were you swim out of the pool and walk up and wrap a towel around yourself and then do like a 30-second promotion.
Oh,
or like out of the steam room, open the door and like the steam comes out and you're standing.
Put the towel on. I'm Matt Myrna, running for Mayor of Toronto. And if you like steam rooms.
Or know where I am.
Or know where I am. Or enjoy being naked. I want your vote. Myrna for naked vote.
I like it.
Hey, people ought to be naked. Speaking of naked, because we got 10 minutes before bud swap, that's where people in the lounge can trade their weed for other people's weed. It's a really cool game. If you haven't played before, get some like nugs out to trade. And if you have played before, we'll do that. We'll bring on Master Rolla after that to talk. He had questions about the new medical marijuana program. We'll talk about the Peace Naturals after the 420 swap, which is also known as bud swap. There's that. Where was I going? I had a point to make about the Aqua Lounge and towels and... Yeah. Oh, naked vote.
We did that.
No, I know where I was going with the naked thing. I didn't know this. Do you ever wonder why there's a few men that do the Pride March naked?
No, God. Where's this going?
Do you ever figure, like, they're like, hey, how can these guys run down the street with their junk out? Do you ever wonder, like, how they can junk it?
It's the one special day where you can do that.
100%. It's the one special day where you can do that.
Wait, it's legally written that way?
It's legally, the case law is, on Pride in Toronto, Torontonians can expect to see nudity. The naked law, the nudity rulings in Ontario are, if you are somewhere where you would expect to see nudity...
The parade route.
It's okay. The parade route. You're fine. You're fine. And it was upheld recently, it goes even further, where a man walked by a Tim Hortons window naked. And the judge was like, no, you're in Tim fucking Hortons drinking a coffee. You're not anywhere near expecting to see the junk hanging out there. So Tim Hortons, you're not allowed
to
get
naked. What if it's a Tim Hortons on the parade route? You got to hold your junk while going by the window?
Well, I don't think the parade route goes through the drive-thru.
Oh.
Don't think so.
I missed that part.
Yeah, so the guy, he was a completely not related to the parade or anything. He was just a complete different case. Where he's like, oh, I was naked. It was a flasher. It's okay. And they're like, no, it's not. It can be. I didn't know that's how the rulings went. I swear to God.
Too bad it wasn't like a one naked day free-for-all. Where anywhere you can expect to see nudity that day.
One day naked day free for all. And if you don't like it, just lock yourself in your home. The one day naked free for all.
No touching, though. Well, no unconsensual touching.
I don't think, as mayor of Toronto, I can offer you the one day a year naked free-for-all.
Yeah, that might damage your campaign.
I can't proclaim naked day.
It's not.
We're not there yet, nudists. I'm sorry.
It's unfortunate.
I can't accommodate naked day.
You have the island beaches, and that's
You got a parade where apparently you can go naked.
Island beaches, a parade.
I don't even have a parade where I can get naked. I do the 420 parade. Nobody expects to see nakedness at 420, I don't think.
A little bit. There's always titties and stuff.
Well, titties count, but, you know, nobody expects to
see
some
guy
with their...
That's legal every time.
Yeah, that's legal every time. Nobody expects to see some guy walking down the street with their junk out on 420. Nor is it called for.
Should be the new expectation.
Could you... You know, and now that we're thinking about 420 and it's all, like, cool at the police and stuff, my new tactic could just be that, just doing the negotiations on 420, start taking my clothes. You should do that in Oshawa, Kyle Stay-Hynet.
We don't need junk on 420.
You don't need...
No, you should just find, like, five friends to do it as a joke and, like, hang out as a group that's, like, for the legalization of marijuana and for the legalization of nudity.
Nudity's pretty legal. However, no cop is expecting you to negotiate with them getting naked. Just start taking your clothes off while you're negotiating. Like, 420 organizers out there, good, take this down as a note. When the cops are, like, asking and doing questions, just start taking your clothes off. And if they're like, what are you doing? You're like, I'm just preparing to be strip searched.
This will be better for both of us if it's consensual.
You know, just get, you imagine those negotiations for four. No cop wants to be like, put your clothes back on.
Wouldn't that be counted as like sexually harassing a police officer?
That would be funny. And I was talking to him and he started taking his clothes off while he was talking to about the imagine negotiating any deal where you start to get naked. What are you doing on this union bargaining a contract? Get naked. Nobody is prepared to negotiate with that guy.
I think people are already starting to mail Health Canada letters. Someone just asked where the nearest mailbox was.
Excellent.
Excellent.
Hit those assholes with as many letters as you can. I mean, they took 8 weeks to get through. Like, I don't know how they expect to get it done in 30 days when it took 6 to 8 weeks to get a fucking license fucking sent to you. I mean, I don't think Health Canada works fast, so they get 100,000 to 200,000 letters, of which they got to get about 40,000, right? They're looking at about 40,000 letters. So in those 40,000, there's another 100,000 that are fakies.
Like one in four.
If one in four was fake, that slows down the machinery pretty good. If
James
one in four
in
were
there.
Fake. And it's such an it's there's nothing illegal about it. Well, except putting, no, there we go.
So it's 8:20 on TMZ and we got Bud Swap.
Excellent, I'm excited.
We're
going to get set up any minute. If you don't know, you can bring your marijuana to the stage and trade it with other people in the room. So Aaron's going to be up there soon.
Excellent. Yeah, so don't be afraid at all to send 20 or 30 letters to Health Canada. No reason to think of frighteningness. So we'll get that up. Yesterday on the Opus show, I participated in the chat, which is probably a mistake. People are laughing.
Probably?
Phil Dabbs is...
You ended up calling at least two people narcs.
At least. And they probably are. I stand by those. Yeah, they got upset with the narc comment, but at the same time, I also called them Queen Street West hipsters.
Right. I think they were more offended by the Queen Street West hipsters.
Aw, like, I love them hipsters.
I called them Queen Street West hipsters. They deserved it, you know. I've never seen the sellout tag except at punk shows and on Queen Street West. Now I see it in the chat room.
I'm saying people are selling out?
Yeah.
How does that make sense?
I don't know. Same as the Queen Street West hipsters, like, you're selling out, but I'm still going to your show.
Right.
I'll accept
so
that.
So far, even on Facebook and in the chat room, there's just this one contingent of people that are saying anybody who buys from these LPs is a sellout and a traitor.
Yep.
Okay. What happens when they're just people that need weed?
Well, the funny thing
they're
is...
They're traitors.
The funny thing is...
You're with us or against us.
Well, the thing is I pointed out to them, like, I'll just retire then, and you can pick up the slack. And in 10 years, we'll see how far you've done. And then Chris is like, I'll retire in 2020. I'm like, fuck. You guys are in trouble if that were to happen. So we up 420 swap. What's going on up here, Goodwin?
Yeah, yeah. If as people might not be aware, if you're new to this, that board up at the stage, you can bring marijuana up to the stage and trade it with other people in the room. So bring up a half gram or a 0.8 or a gram or a 1.2. There's no pressure, so you don't have to trade if you don't like the trade. And you can ask people to size up or size down, or they'll ask you. And you can also trade for dabs or hash or anything like that.
Myrna's got the first bud on the board. What is it?
No, it's just an unknown.
I know, and it looks really nice.
It does look really nice, though. I mean, if I busted it up and smoked it, I could guess it's probably like OG 18 or...
What's... Go ahead.
This is Amnesia Haze.
Amnesia Haze?
Oh, Holy Grail Kush and Amnesia Haze. Good choices.
That's the Holy Grail and the Amnesia.
All right. And then hang out here, buddy.
Master Bubba and OG Shark.
Oh, those are nice, too.
Combo.
Vanilla Kush is always a good one.
Mm-hmm.
The Island Skunk. All right. Young man, you're...
Nice selection.
Good selection. Who wants to go first?
Robert in the chat room says nice nails, Aaron.
Yeah.
She does that on purpose, of course.
That's
an unknown as well.
You got people with hand fetishes in the room.
Yeah.
But this is actually aged from what I got from like 2 weeks ago or something.
I put the vanilla kush next to the Holy Grail kush, and then I'm moving these unknowns because these are all unknowns.
Yeah, you touch that weed.
Could somebody say yeah, it's over there.
I'm allowed to say that.
This one. And now we've got some shatter on the board.
I see Opus is here.
What have you got, Opus?
Well, I have my Burmese.
So he was going to offer some Burmese for the Island Sweet Scum.
Burmese for the Island.
Wow, that board's getting filled.
It's a done deal. So this is Opus. This is Kyle's. Thanks, guys.
You in the green, yeah.
Jenny from Peace Naturals.
Ooh, we're already trading LP strains.
Calm. It's nice to see the variety. This is Myrna's Unknown. Are you interested in the Vanilla Kush?
What's it look like? Does it look good, Aaron? Looks good, eh? Looks heavy. That looks good. Yeah, take a look at it, the Vanilla Kush guy. Take a look at that. He's happy. I'm happy.
It's a good deal.
Cool.
Done.
Do it up.
In there?
Yeah, throw it in there and I'll forget what it is in a minute. See, already I'm like, oh, there it is. But
this one is the Holy Grail Kush, and that's Amnesia. The master for the grail. Who's Holy Grail? For this master.
Oh, sure, yeah.
Done. Grab your buds. So you can't see, but these are great little like rubber cookware safe type dishes for your shatter. Keeps them clean.
Those are cool. I like them. So 420 swap, we got some guys up here. It's moving at. I like the pace it's moving at. All right, guys, who's up next? Okay.
This one is
Unknown
Tamara
from Smash,
Unknown.
And she's taken weight. Nah, probably taken bud because she's not on break, so she's like, she mentioned to me before she was got off to go hang out.
What'd she
like,
want?
She wanted weight, the equivalent in weight.
She could size down and get a different variety.
Yeah,
of
she'd have to bust it.
This is the Amnesia and the Jenny.
What'd you think of that, Jenny?
Yeah, this is the Peace Natural strain. It's a new licensed producer for the government.
So he's happy because he got a license, yeah.
It looked like a really, that was the Jenny was the most unique looking one on the board. It had a great color. There's more Jenny available.
Yeah.
two unknowns and then shatter.
That's a good decision on the cure job there.
This almost looks the same. She'd probably do that.
What?
I'm not sure. If he sized up this pile for her.
Smash, come on up. Where are you at?
That looks pretty even already, though.
I know, it does.
All right.
That's some shatter for shatter.
It's a big bud.
Yeah.
Shatter for shatter.
It's two different strains, a variety. I don't want a bunch of little ones. She wants a big bud to match hers.
All right, then.
Oh, jeez. That's picky.
That is picky.
Yeah.
It's easier to bust those little ones up. You're going to have to break them down anyway.
No thanks. Yeah. I get
that's true,
more surface area.
Did I just miss the swap of the unknown and I guess some more Jenny?
Did they do that?
That was pretty quick. I saw
it happened
that.
So quick, but I heard them talking about it. Just so everyone knows the rules of the game, the swap has to happen all on camera.
They did put it up there and moved it. They moved pretty quick,
didn't violate
it
any rules.
It was within the rules, but
it was within the rules, but very. It was done quick.
Yeah.
You got some small, but I'll put some weed up there if no one's trading. Anyone trading on
that?
What was?
What were the strains that are mixed in here? The Master Bubba and the OG Shark. Mm-hmm. So he's offering this for however much of that.
Yeah, just match it up.
If you want to pull out a few buds, he'll trade you those if you're... Dion.
I'll trade with you, you know. Whatever you want to flip with, man. Whatever you feel is fair. Aaron does all my fair trades, so I'm not in... You know, just whatever you feel it's fair. Aaron's up there helping you out a bit. They're pretty light and fluffy, Aaron, so. There you go. Aaron, no, she's fair. We want to make sure everyone goes home fair and not feeling cheated. The host cheated me. Said, there we go. Yeah, whatever.
Happy?
Are you happy?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm cool.
So this is now yours?
Yep.
And it's nice. Chris
That's
and
the
I
idea.
Always say that we mix our buds together and break them down like that, so. It really gives you all the different strain profiles.
It's good thing that BC judge isn't watching this, eh? He's shitting himself. It's an unknown. Often we call it just Red Cup number one. Because sometimes some of the
Some people are saying online that this might... Well, it's only Valley Boy and Rom. But the one point they made was this might be an example of diversion. How say you?
I say that this is a bunch of people trading marijuana.
Right.
Is this the hash from yesterday? Made with dry ice on Opus
nice.
Live.
I'm not a big fan of dry ice.
Everyone
hash.
Who was here yesterday for Opus Live got like a spoonful of hash. Leprechaun Bong Man walked around and spooned out hash for everyone in the audience. I've been smoking everyone all day. It was a nice treat.
I think people who speak negatively of people swapping marijuana aren't marijuana people. You speak negative about people swapping weed.
I know, eh? How dare you pass a joint?
Yeah.
Pass it to the left is diversion.
Hash just dropped?
Well, there's a... You know, we got to trade. We got to create strain
hey Dion,
sample
this is your
variety
unknown?
Ourselves, man.
Are you going to trade it for a couple of these buds?
I'm looking forward to the day now that we've done a couple Peace Natural swaps to someone trading a tweed for Peace Naturals because you know what? That's when it doesn't become diversion. That's when it's coming to variety, Your Honor.
That's so cool.
Your Honor,
you made the cool point. Like someone just said, though, the people online are saying it is diversion. We're saying it might be or it's not. But we should get a third party to rule on it, which is why I brought that up.
So
you made
that
the
was
comment.
The OG Shark and the Master Bubba for the unknown.
That it'd be funny if the judge was watching this.
Well, it's the only way to get strain variety. And see, that would be presuming someone up here is a medical. I fucking know if anybody's medical. I'm not in the program. Not the old program. It's just people stuck at home crying. What's going on there? You trading a big fat bud for some shatter? Is that what you're doing? Dan, are you trading big fat bud for some shatter there?
That's what's happening.
That's what's happening?
So shatter for the Burmese.
It looks like a good trade there.
And then, it's so funny because you were right in the chat room the other day. Like, Rom and Valley Boy are basically saying, let's call up Peace Naturals and see what they think about this. But that's narc-type talk.
Told you they were narcs.
It totally is. Like, the same thing applies to compassion clubs, right? If you go to Toronto Compassion Center or Calm,
that's your hash?
You do sign an agreement that you're not going to sell any or whatever. But passing a joint to somebody else is the same thing, and trading it on bud swab is the same thing.
Exactly.
But no one's going, let's call Toronto Compassion Center, let's call Calm and let them know that one of their patients is trading marijuana. It's such a silly narc type.
That's mentality. A narc in my, that's as low as the Health Canada press release in my book.
Right.
That's how low you're acting.
Right.
Acting like a Queen Street West hipster calling
you can hold out if you like. So there's still a few buds. Anyone who wants to just trade like a small nugget of their own in the room, you can come up and get a different variety that you haven't tried.
This is the only open market in the world where people can come in here and trade weed with other people.
Because you know how when you smoke
your
own strain?
No currency at all. There, that screws you freebie, people. You got to at least start somewhere. So you got to bring bud and then trade your bud with other people, bud.
Right.
So right now there's still some of this hash.
It's like
chatter.
An anarchist thing going on
the
here.
It's obviously that the definition of trafficking includes bartering and trading and passing, giving, receiving. Not just the sale for money.
Just so people are, but whatever.
Right.
Only people who call the cops or call someone are really dicks. Besides, I always wanted to see, hey, Your Honor, I brought marijuana in and traded with someone, and then I arrested Matt Myrna on his show a week later. I'd be okay with that.
Let's first call, like, Rom's mom and ask her if she's okay with it.
I climbed off his mom the other night. Monday.
Who?
Rom's mom.
You banged her?
Yeah,
you could,
totally
you could,
climbed off her Monday.
Size it up or just size down his, whichever you guys prefer. Can add a couple more
trades
buds.
Trades are going
and then
great
he'll
up
get
here.
I love watching these trades. I'm fascinated.
So are you guys okay with that swap?
My throat's
or
sore.
Are you okay with those buds?
You guys are doing
great tonight.
So here,
that's yours.
I'll throw some
yours.
More bud on there. It's
getting such a mix in there. So this unknown is yours. Are you interested in getting hash or there's some shatter? This bud here is an unknown. If you
Dan
guys want to trade
might
that.
Might trade Keith with it. I don't know.
Or you
yeah,
could
you want to
swap. So this is Myrna's, and you can take that off the board.
Hmm. Thank you. I always try and make sure someone goes home with a swap.
I know, because like I was saying, you're smoking the same like quarter or whatever you get from your dealer, and then after the initial day or two of smoking it, it doesn't have the same
pop.
So it's
nice
your body to
get gets adjusted
a variety.
To it.
And Smash's big butt is still here.
But there's no studies that strain variety does anything. No studies.
No, there are none, actually.
Right, none.
Yet.
Do you
because
know
you can.
Bud?
How do you do...
Do you know the type?
No, I think it's... I don't
That
I don't
big butt's still sitting there.
Yeah.
Lonely. Big. All by itself. Anybody in the room got a big bud? An equivalent cola to trade?
Or like
three medium buds she'd approve of as well.
I don't know.
An unknown.
And I can't believe people would actually threaten to call, like, the man on us.
The man.
Threatening.
That's how it appears in the phone book, the man.
It does. Totally does.
Mm-hmm.
Some serious contemplation going on over there.
And then,
I wouldn't even... They're talking about butter and bud for the hash, potentially?
Is that what they're working? They're trying to work a three-person deal, like...
Three ways are harder to pull off.
Like,
this is Master Kush? Oh, Rockstar Kush for some of this butter.
He's trying to match you there, Smash.
I'm getting excited. Yeah, mash that up, Aaron.
So you want me to size this down?
People are asking, what's the difference in shatter? And then somebody answered, it's just not air whipped. And then people are asking if that's even true or not.
Good,
or
good to see you.
But I think that's the case. I think normal butter is just, it's been whipped and turned, and air is added to, like, every molecule or something, and then it comes out looking and feeling that way, I think.
Hydrogenated, yeah.
I'm hearing people say pretty much.
So I just busted Smash's bud. Are you okay with that, everyone?
Yeah. I can't really see, but yeah.
Do you want to look at this bud?
No.
This is the bud you're going to get? Well, this is your bud.
Yeah.
I do.
All right.
Nice. So there we go. Lots of good trades going on tonight.
An unknown.
But I'll get you there.
There's been lots of like nicely grown unknown on the board tonight.
It happens. Get your labeling mixed up.
People ask me my strain, and because I mix them all together, I'm like,
thank you. Yeah, this is great.
It's this or that.
Those guys are working out something over there. They've been steadily at work.
So, Dion, are you interested in trading this shatter for that? He's just in the middle of another transaction.
We got this guy trading shatter, too. It's excellent.
So the narc admits that he's actually a rat, not a narc. Get it right. So.
Just nobody saying. Likes that guy in jail. Either or. I just think you dedicate that much time to us. You got to be doing something.
Wow, the screen just went really red there for a second.
I don't know. There's a big shatter deal they're trying to work out there.
So they're trading this for that. They're going to have to switch their dishes.
Is that what they're talking about? Or maybe they're even agreeing to the same with the dish?
I think they're going to...
Yeah, see?
Yeah, they're going to empty out their oil and keep their own dishes.
Now we got Dan coming up here. I don't know what Dan's up to. Oh.
They're whispering off mic. Work-related.
It was a work-related incident.
All right.
So is this, all this stuff you're doing is going to get this hash traded?
No, it's a little different.
Okay.
So the debate still is raging on about the same guys writing that shatter is properly purged, but butter is full of contaminants and crap. But I don't think that's true. I just think it's after they've both been purged, one is air whipped and the other is let.
I'll bring my expert next week on the show, Mark, who is my expert on the issue, and he'll explain it. And if we had Danger here, Danger could have explained it, and I would accept him as my expert witness also.
I'm sure someone here...
He can submit his affidavit next week.
So next week, yeah, J. Danger will...
Air whipping in parts contaminants? I don't understand how that's possible.
Are you guys...
Although I might get made fun of, but when I made candles...
So are you trading this bud and...
A lot of paraffin wax candles are poured and dried... To look almost like shatter looks, or almost like, you know. But some candles are air whipped that are more meant for like churches, and they actually have the same. The wax has the same feeling as some of these.
So he kept his own container and changed the lid, or what was that?
It was just a whole like put it in the lid, and then I have my dish to put mine in.
Cool.
And then this dab, bud, and hash is all getting traded for this dark hash.
Huh. Well, that's cool.
And then Smash still has a fair-sized bud on the board to trade.
Yeah.
I see.
You're not interested in getting any kind of extra?
No, I can, like, swap again.
Hmm?
I can swap again, but I don't know what's going on with the board.
But you don't want any hash or oil.
Oh, no.
Just weed.
Don't have the unit.
Man, it feels like someone's smashing me right upside the left side of my face today. All here.
Ugh.
Oh, brain tumor acting up like a motherfucker.
Meditating earlier?
No, I did Pilates and all that, but it's just something. Just not feeling it.
So
tonight.
We just passed 25 minutes of bud swap.
Excellent.
It's been a good one.
They move at the pace I like them moving at.
So this
yeah, it's been a great pace.
It's the perfect
pace.
This
is clearing, and this is still available, as well as this bud.
Push that bud down more. All right.
Now I'm really, like, feeling the pain. That's a good amount of hash. There you go. You got it. There you go.
That's from Opus Live yesterday.
People were really enjoying that dry ice hash.
Huh.
Mm-hmm. Worth waiting for. A
couple people tweeted about it. They were like, first time I've ever tried hash in my life.
Nice.
From Opus. He went around handing it out, and it was a big hit.
No, she's looking for bud.
Well, it looks like unless Dion's the last guy on the board. Well.
All right, I can. Oh, wow, okay. Yeah, sure. Wait, didn't you just trade tonight for that?
Yeah.
Oh, no, keep the Burmese. I know how much you like it. It's okay. I'll just take one back.
Gonna take hers back?
All right.
Come in with a really big bud. This is the risky
run. It was good that
run.
We had a good length segment on that.
Thanks.
So, good one. What you, and Aaron's up here too. What you guys think of the. We went down and we saw the Peace Naturals facility on Friday.
Right.
What you think?
Okay, so it all depends on...
A lot of people were like, hey, it didn't look that big. I would agree, it wasn't the biggest.
I expected bigger rooms, but they had many smaller rooms.
Yeah, and they are intending to expand.
Have you seen the pictures of some of the other LPs? Like, all stainless steel rooms, all, like... I don't know. But so you made the quote that... Rom keeps quoting, which is that, and although this is one that I thought about too, this is exactly what I would expect, like a medical marijuana pharmacy, whatever, to grow to look like.
Yeah, it's
and so
clean.
They're making fun of that, but it right. all depends on how you come from what your statement meant.
I meant that it was clean.
Well, you also meant that it could be done by a regular Joe.
Yeah,
these guys were just like. Regular guys our age with some other regular farmer, and there's
but
only four.
But they were PhDs, and
well, you know, they also play Skyrim and enjoy baseball and rocking out.
Right,
right. So it's hard when you,
they're cool
yeah,
dudes.
They, you know, they are pretty well educated. The guy's got a PhD, so when it comes to him talking about nitrogen uptake of right, when it comes to talking about topics like nitrogen uptake, I assure you. I'm pretty good at following along on nitrogen uptake, and I remember him mentioning it to me. We were talking about it. I have fertilization out on camera. We were just talking about fertilization and the uptake on the plant and how most of it just stays in your soil or your mass. It's not used. And then he started talking about being like how his pH, and you're just like, I was down there, like I was following along, and then you went like, right over my head. Like, you just took off there into PhD land. Like, I could follow a lot of good conversations on pot and fertilization, And then they're just like, boom.
Okay, so wait, what I was saying was when you said that's what we'd expect a facility to look like, I was actually expecting it to look more like a jail or a hospital. Like concrete walls, concrete floors, but that are smooth.
Yeah.
Everything's stainless steel and cleaned and whatever, and clearly, like, no, I don't know, no clutter.
I was
clutter.
Expecting it more laboratory as well.
More laboratory.
But so I think what Chris did question Mark about some of the materials being used, and Mark's answer to that was that until you test and trial and know what works, so over time, they'll have a better idea of what they actually need and the right dimensions, the right shapes, the right sizes. So yep. I expect in a year or two from now, when we would revisit the location, you would see all kinds of improvements made.
Oh, within Absolutely. A year, I would think for sure. But
well, yeah,
it's so easy, which it was, I guess Chris's point was that, or my point being is that, yeah, this is medical marijuana at a pharmaceutical grade level. Like, I contacted two people when we got back, and I said, your grow will qualify for an LP license. Like, I have been in DG grows that are, that's why some people are going to get them. You're just like, I have been in grows that are very close to the same level of standard that they're bringing.
Well,
like,
I think that's why people are getting so upset. They say, my weed is grown well enough. I keep my place clean. Why am I not given this? It's because you have to go through the obstacles of being registered in the program and following all the guidelines. Yep. The security, they didn't really want us to feature that in the broadcast. It was
off limits.
But I was very impressed at the level of security that people aren't aware of that's being taken.
I mean, they wear panic buttons.
I don't know if we're supposed to talk about much of it, but yeah, it was like...
Like, there's some serious high-level
security. Serious
levels
are being taken.
And I think that's where the most expense... I talked to a couple other LPs, and they're all saying that's the biggest expense.
Like, I think
the
alarm company calls the police. Like, I think it's an immediate...
It's an immediate, like, boom!
The police are notified.
We are here!
Goes on, yeah.
Everything is here. And so... I don't... I mean, Chris's point, and we're like thinking, is that it's not the biggest barrier to entry to some of the people in the marijuana movement type stuff. I don't see it like...
And like those last Skype guests we had that were packing up their grow and saying they're going to retry at a different location, there's all kinds of little obstacles people might overcome, like might have
right.
to overcome. But as long as you keep at it, yeah, it's possible for most people who are interested in doing it to get there.
Yeah, and each no is an opportunity.
Especially the DGs. Like I said, I talked to two growers that were DGs, and I was like, your facility is pretty close to being exactly what I saw. Other than they had broke up all their rooms by doors, you know.
Some of the statements online, like one guy's writing, flowers are not pharmaceuticals, and the reason the LPs lie about it is to justify their prohibition prices. But
that's a silly argument. Next.
Well, it's weird that the medical marijuana and the marijuana movement in general in the United States and Canada has moved towards medical marijuana, so it doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, next.
They've asked for it to be a pharmaceutical.
I know. Some people are asking for it to be a pharmaceutical, and there's another guy asking for it not. Somebody's like on my Facebook's like, man, there's a guy on Myrna's Facebook wall demanding the government pay for his weed. And this guy's like, I'm like against Obamacare. Like, you're just like, Americans can't make any heads or tail of that one in the marijuana community.
I saw two or three posts in the last 24 hours. People actually, instead of us being invested in these companies, they actually think they're paying you. I saw two or three posts from people that think Myrna's being paid by LPs.
No, that's not. If you'll note, we declare.
They're offering you stock options.
100%.
Right.
Yeah. And just journalism ethics, Chris, if you watch the Bedrocan interview, at the start of the Bedrocan interview, I declared conflict of interest. If you see in the latest Olivia Chow article I wrote on cannabis culture, someone asked if they thought I was journalistic ethics by writing a blog post on Chow, who inhaled marijuana, by the way. Olivia Chow, there you go. Inhaled marijuana. Go figure.
Maybe we should refer to Smoke and Joint as Chow Time.
I think we should refer to smoking joints as Chow Time for sure. I love it. So we do declare all ethics of journalism there, right, Goodwin?
Right.
Yeah, yeah, Matt's not available for that sort of thing, but I am.
Besides, if they were, we would demand large sums of money, and then every 30 or 40 minutes it'd say something like, "This is Matt Myrna. You should get," whatever it is those commercials are.
Should buy weed from these people.
So that's silly. And if that were the case, hopefully we could monetize, but you can't take out advertising. So I think people that come up with these types of statements, again, I have 10 years. You've seen what I've done. There's the bar. Go at her.
And know this. That's the other bar.
Yeah. So I think that's fair to say. If you want to like throw rocks and stuff at my accomplishments, there's the bar. In other words, you got to go and strike down the weed law. You got to organize about 10 years worth of weed rallies. Get arrested a half dozen times.
Have your weed taken by the cops and your bong and given back.
And given back. So there you guys have it. I gladly retire. Like, I'm glad. Hey, if you're like, man, I'm going to do this, I'm like, fuck, go for it. I'm getting old. I'll gladly just show up.
Oh,
time's
my God.
Myrna getting here. Oh, closer to 4:20 from like 3 o'clock to 4:20.
I have a fun idea. The day that you got your bong back from the police, on that day, every year, we should have like marijuana Olympics. And then we can have the baton race, but then we're holding a bong.
That'd be an idea.
Baton, and then we can have like a huge Olympic theme day. Huh.
So I just think a lot of people in the chat these days are just acting like a bunch of Queen West hipsters. Fucking whiny fucks. Let's bring up Master Rolla.
Yes.
He's got questions about this new medical marijuana program. And it comes from some of his YouTube people, too. He's been... We want to get him more onto the show. Grab that mic over there, Master Rolla. Have you been...
Didn't bring any glass today?
I do have a little, actually, yeah. If Kyle would help me out.
Well, have you been busy working this week?
Yeah, I'm quite enjoying the warmer weather we've been having. I'm looking forward to March, the... forecasts are looking to be in my favor and everyone else who works in my field. So I want you to check this one out, Matt. That's an actual that's an actual piece of cannabis in the electroform as the handle on that bowl.
That's right. We've been talking about electroforming. Tell the people at home what it is.
Essentially what it's doing is it's creating electrical current through the glass that attracts the copper particles to build up on its outer surface. And with a conductive paint, I can essentially electroform anything, including a cannabis leaf that I put on another dabber, which turns out pretty neat. It's a neat effect that...
That is really amazing.
Yeah.
That's a weed leaf, and it's electroformed. Damn, sneaking one. We got the bud there. So you've been electroforming stuff.
I have been experimenting around with it, having a great time. It's a bit of a passive art, which is sort of...
So it's just immortalized inside of it?
For the bud, yeah, it's preserved essentially forever now. I can't imagine that ever.
It's a nice handle.
Spoiling.
Chris, do you want to switch the cams there?
I have to turn it sideways a bit.
There you go.
Yeah, nice simple little dome with a.
So you
as a handle.
Electroformed it, and
it's
then stuck it on a piece
person.
Of glass. So that's a bud on a. Yeah.
Reminds me of coral.
Yeah, it does sort of look like that. I'm almost interested to try and cheat and put other things that sort of resemble a bud in it and then call it a bud because I can't exactly ship that one over the border, can I?
Oh, yeah.
I think that might be considered trafficking.
Yeah. Things are... so your glass is going good?
Oh, definitely. Actually, yeah, I'm enjoying it more than ever right now, so...
You're on a creative peak, then.
I am a bit of a turning point as well. So I'm looking forward to 2014 as a year that's going to be pretty good for me.
Nice. Well, because you can't just explain quickly. You have a hard. You can't blow as much glass in the real cold time because.
Well, for proper glass blowing, it requires a huge amount of ventilation because when you put the heat in the flame, which is a propane oxygen mixed flame, it creates a lot of carbon monoxide. Carbon dioxide, and then colored glasses also have metals in them that cause metal fuming to occur. And as you can imagine, any of that being inhaled would probably be pretty bad for you. So with 1,000 cubic feet of ventilation space, the air has to come from somewhere. So in the wintertime, the air comes from outside. So you're essentially standing in a wind tunnel of whatever temperature it is outdoors.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Minus 20 degrees.
And you have a YouTube channel. What's your YouTube channel?
Yeah, I have a YouTube channel where I post rolling tutorials, demonstrations of different pieces of glass I make, as well as buy, and demonstrations on different vaporizers as well. And it's MASTAHROLLA, Mastarolla is the YouTube name there.
And you said you guys had some questions regarding the MMPR on your channel and stuff. So.
Well, definitely.
And in general, yeah.
Yeah, over the last several months, as more and more information has come to light on the new MMPR program, it gets a little bit confusing for some people because there's a lot of misinformation out there. People giving their input when they're not quite knowledgeable enough to provide the correct information. And then you have 10 people relay that misinformation. And as you can imagine, we're now at, 2 weeks out from the program coming into full effect, as much as it can for a new piece of legislature. But I thought this might be a good opportunity to clear up some of the
We can do the best we can because we've been focused on that theme all night. So let's continue onward. This is good.
Absolutely. So first, from the general idea, I get a... Do you think that this is a positive thing or for better or for worse for the general population?
For the general So the one thing we always stand by is we don't believe that people should lose their opportunity to grow their own.
Right.
In terms of the replacement of the designated grower system, I think this is an excellent move in the perfect direction the way it should be going. I think more people will buy from a company, I guess, so to speak, then go to a compassion club. I think the application process is tremendously easier, and that's what the one part I'm looking at is these private companies are going to want your doctor to sign your paperwork. I know Kyle Stahinetz here. He had one license that he paid a doctor for, and then your family doctor the second time signed you up? Sure, take a... So what was your experience? You were in the old program.
Right. Is this on now? Okay. So yeah, I was not on the old program. I was unfortunate to get I couldn't get on it, right?
Okay.
I spent about like a year and a half to 2 years trying to get on the old program. Like you pretty much had to be almost dying in an aspect to get on there, right?
Okay.
And it's just I would have had to pay $250 to see a pain specialist doctor.
Right.
And then $50+ on traveling with my disability would have never covered, right? So it would have been coming out of the money that they provide to me. It's really ridiculous, and I don't really don't. I don't like.
So your family doctor filled out the new paperwork?
Yeah, I brought to him the Peace Naturals forms. There weren't many at all, and then he read something from Health Canada online, and within 5 minutes or so, he was able to sign it without issues. And then, they called him. I don't know what the process is with them calling. I'm actually really
curious. They called because you signed a medical release.
Yeah, I'm really curious.
And they called to confirm that he filled it out.
Yeah, I'm really curious what he had to say, honestly, about that for sure, right?
They just call up and say, hey.
I just want to speak to him. I'm going to go see him. I'm going to see the whole thing, right? Why not?
So that's cool. It's good that – so his doctor and we're seeing – hopefully more doctors.
Yeah,
he can
awesome.
Sit down
I didn't
now.
Have to pay any money at all whatsoever to have my doctor sign it. It was lovely.
Because the application appears to be easier.
Right, and it's my family
well, it
doctor
doesn't appear.
All my life, right?
So, it is easier. It's
so
the new...
freaking easy.
The Peace Naturals now is down to like one page on a prescription like pad-looking item. So these private companies...
I didn't put a reason of why I'm on the thing at all. I didn't have to sign that form. I didn't
There's
want
no
to,
illness good. Requirement. He's right. There's no illness requirement, so anybody can get on.
Yeah, I'm not
well,
on that.
That actually leads me
reason.
To right,
Kyle,
one of the
thanks.
Questions from Carmeet23, and he's asking, hi, I'm 18 years old, living in Ontario, and I have anxiety problems, gaining weight, sleep apnea, and minor depression. Would it be possible for me to get a card, and does insurance cover costs of these meds? Thanks so much, bud.
Answer to the first part, yes, you can definitely get into the new medical marijuana program because Kyle said you don't have to have an illness. So that is the biggest part of this program is like, no illness requirement.
And what about his age? Is that a factor?
Not a factor.
Is it at 18 or?
Doesn't matter.
Really? Okay.
You can, if a family doctor wants to prescribe it to an epileptic child, go for it. In terms of private insurance, no, not covered.
Not covered by a private insurance.
Nor is it covered by government insurance.
Right.
Veterans Affairs pays? Blue Cross. Okay. Veterans of, I didn't know that. Okay, Veterans Affairs. Excellent.
I also heard, too, that Veterans Affairs is either looking at adding it to the authorized list, already authorizes parts of it, and is looking at authorizing more, something like that.
That's huge news, so yeah.
But that's weird that the government is allowing it for its own veterans.
Yeah.
I brought that up last week on the show, that the one, yeah, veterans.
Well, so they're supposed to have, like, an all-inclusive access to everything.
That's excellent news. So there you go. That's, I mean, it's mostly no, but glimmer of hope.
There is some access, and maybe in the future we'll see more.
Yeah.
So we were talking about for better or for worse for the general population, and I got the idea that you think it's sort of for the worse for the severely ill or the patients that are currently needing to grow to afford their medicine.
Oh, yeah. People growing their own are getting screwed.
Yeah.
Hence the reason, you know, we're doing some of the stuff that we're doing that people didn't think we thought they were getting screwed, but I know it's not the licensed producer's fault. It's that their angst should be taken out on their MP and Health Canada. Those are the people that are really, you know, the RCMP is boot fucking people.
The LPs are doing a good service and are doing a so far a fairly good job at offering that from what
I
can see.
They're doing what they see a business opportunity, and some of them are going to try and do a different, depends on their business model, right? Some are growing a certain method and some are going to irradiate. Some are going to try and listen to people in the cannabis culture and some are just going to be like, fuck it, I don't need them. So,
by the way, we heard some big news about that as well, the choice and which way direction. Philip Lucas, the director of Vancouver Island Compassion Society, better known as VIX.
Do you know that for sure, though?
Was told to us that they're in their third stage of approval.
I mean, you don't know that for sure.
Obviously, I don't.
This is something to look forward to.
You shouldn't throw that around on the show.
No, but what I'm getting at is that there are...
Well, what I'm getting at is that you can't say that, like, if you don't know.
Well, you can say that I don't know.
They're not on the website yet.
Right? So continue on. Like, you can't, like...
I'm saying that there's 11 now, and out of those 300 that applied, some of them are going to be your local compassion club.
Some of them are Ross Bibliotti.
Some are Ross Bibliotti. Some are your old DGs.
Yeah.
And they're already applying. They're already trying to get through those three levels of approval that it takes to become an LP.
But we are hearing that. We are hearing that. Definitely hearing that type of stuff.
So, like, what will the program be when a cooperative, and I'm not sure how he's going to run it as an LP if they get approved, and what I said is even true, but given all those things, Vancouver Island, Compassion Society could run a licensed producer co-op of sorts. I'm not sure how, but...
I don't know. So.
It'll be interesting. And then here in Toronto, Calm is also trying to apply, but they're a for-profit compassion club.
The whole idea with that, I've been looking into it, actually. It's basically just anybody who wants to be part of that is going to have to be a part owner of the company. So you're going to have to equally invest into the company. That's the whole idea.
Yeah. All right.
Kyle was talking about how his doctor just signed the forms and didn't request a prescription fee or anything like that. How do you think people should react if they find a doctor that asks for payment to sign the forms?
See, that's a difficult question. I mean, there's still... I get an email today of a signing clinic going on. It's a very personal decision. Like, if you feel, you know, that you want to pay it and go that route, that's your decision. I can't tell you what to say. I mean, like, it's really a personal choice. It's in my personal choice is that I refuse to pay. I want to go the family doctor route, and you know, if someone chooses to go the other route, that's their decision. I'm not pro or against them.
Well, Chris J says, hey, I would like to get a card. How do I ask my doc? Because I have a brain injury and I have ADD and ADHD. So how should he approach his doctor to discuss the medical cannabis?
Oh, well, that's like one of the best discussions. Like, it's really a discussion with your doctor on medical cannabis can be a little bit frustrating. Your doctor may kick you out of his office. He's going to be, might get upset. So there's some of that. But a lot of doctors might, or some doctors are getting better at and more receptive and want to hear from you. Chances are, if you're already using medical marijuana, your doctor is, you know, when you bring up the conversation, you would be like, I find medical marijuana, I'm using marijuana, I find it's working for me medically, here's what I find, how it's working for me. And then have a company application with you already filled out and say, are you interested in signing me up to one of these licensed producers? And have the information there. The licensed producers will gladly walk your doctor through the process. Because, of course, at the end of the day, they want your business.
Right. I mean, it sort of makes sense there, absolutely. So when you're getting your prescriptions filled, you get it. You go online to the actual licensed producer and you download an application from them? Is that how the process starts?
That's where the process starts to get in, yeah. Go to a licensed producer, download their application.
Not necessarily. There's a Health Canada sample form that you could use for any of them.
Yeah, but most aren't accepting them, Chris. So just that's why we have to go that
route. No, they have to accept the Health Canada, the form, but then they can force you to fill out form 2 and 3. So then you'll have to, with Peace Naturals, fill out a new client form. And then form 3 is that form from Health Canada doesn't authorize you or them to talk to your doctor. So that authorization. So yes, you have to continue the process. But the first sample form still works.
So if you want to make your life real easy, just download their application.
True.
So that's the best.
So I don't know why you even said that.
I'm just... But you guys went... How do you start... Anyways, starting
it
up.
There's more forms is what Chris is saying.
I should have brought in the booklet that they gave me.
Well, that's what I thought you were going to do.
Fuck. We were busy coming in today.
Okay, then.
But it's just new client business. I mean...
So go and download the application on a license. They got a better one, buddy. It's even easier.
It's one page, small one page.
That's a small one page, so it's gotten, like, they're down to one page on the application.
Okay, and then you take...
It's, like, literally smaller than an 8x10 page.
And how long would it take for the doctor to fill that out?
A doctor could fill it out in his office. If it's that one page or the downloaded form, you can literally fill out most of it for your family doctor. It's like your name, address, phone number on most of the pages, a couple signatures. Send it, and then your family doctor signs into one spot.
The form has the doctor's address information, your address information, and then the only information they have to put is how many grams per day.
Yep.
So there's a little spot that says how many grams per day where they're supposed to fill that number in, and then a little blank spot that says for how many months. So up to 12 months, it says. So... So that is the only information they have to put, and it's like a yellow and a white form. They tear it off. That's it. A prescription
pad. They keep
pad.
The yellow, and awesome. You yeah. probably get the white.
And to complicate things, you could have them fill out two 1.5 gram per day applications for two different LPs.
Well, sure. Yep.
You if could they wanted to give you.
You
three
could
grams
download
day.
Forms from several and have your doctor fill out different gram amounts for different groups. For sure, you could.
You could have them fill out 10 1-gram forms, like if you had a 10-gram-a-day limit.
You should, like, discuss this all with your doctor, though, before you just come with the forms.
Yeah.
Of course, that part is something that the doctor should be filling
subtlety.
Out.
Subtlety.
You know.
Yeah, but the first step, when you go to your doctor to say that medical marijuana works for you, bring the forms with you and just say, I'd like to leave this with you. And have it all filled out, ready to go, and just needing his signature so he or she can look into it.
Yeah.
And Seymour Butts' mother is complaining because she uses edibles and tinctures, and the licensed producers are only producing the flower.
They're only allowed to do that.
So concentrates are illegal.
Everything else is off the board, unfortunately.
Yeah.
But I suspect, again, that as the program evolves, they'll get to that point of edibles and tinctures and stuff. But at this point... You know,
because
that's sort of like the Compassion Center. Like, they started to get edibles after they were established.
Heck, when I went the first time I went to a Compassion Club, I think they had two strains on the menu. 97. Like, fuck. Serious. People bitching and stuff about strains and edibles and stuff. I'm like, fucking 1997. When we wore an onion around our waist, because it was the style at the time on Queen Street.
It's like...
There's two strains of pot.
Chronic and Skunk.
Chronic and Skunk, exactly. You are fucking lucky if White Widow is on the menu.
It's almost too bad that you can't get the extracts and concentrates from the LPs, because from what I've seen, they send out like a detailed analysis of the... Of what's contained within it, the THC, CBD, CBN, that sort of thing.
They definitely send out detailed analysis, so that hopefully it'd be great if you got.
And that's something you don't even get on current dispensary oils. You know, you actually don't know how pure that oil is, and if it's coming from a licensed producer, I'd expect that they put the same quality control as they would on the flower.
That's some of the, you know, so some, those things will be done in time, I'm sure. That's what people don't, like, I'm trying to say, is like day one, first year, it's all coming in time. I guarantee it'll happen. It'll just, these guys will put pressure on government to allow them to sell tincture, allow them to create edibles. Like, they're, unlike me, Health Canada returns their phone calls. You know. So those are, I mean... It appears that access may be better because they want you in the program, right? Mm-hmm. Where the government is like, fuck these people. Yeah. So they want to make it as easy peasy on you. They want to get you in there to buy the marijuana from them. So, mm-hmm. Of course, they want to make access as easy as can be.
They butter that slope.
Yeah.
And I know we've talked about this before on your show, but what can you expect from sort of the price range for cannabis per gram from these licensed producers?
Well, right now, I think the range I'm seeing reported is between 6 and 12.
Which is fairly reasonable.
Yeah, and Peace and Tweed both have compassionate Robin Hood programs. So at least two of the companies we checked with have already said, we understand it's not affordable to you people. So we're going to have we're going to have a compassionate program. So... Peace Natural says 4% of all their sales are actually at zero. So it makes them no money. 4% of what they sell is done compassionately.
And dispensaries under the new laws, how are they going to react?
Well, dispensaries have always been illegal. They make them sort of like, in the new ones they say they're specifically not allowed, which I found was weird. And dispensaries will, from what I hear, dispensaries are going to remain open.
I've gotten a call from one of the dispensaries that I'm, that I have a card with, and they suggested that they may be working with licensed producers. So if you're a customer of a certain licensed producer, you can go to them and get the medicine directly from them instead of having it mailed. Have you heard anything about that?
I haven't heard anything about that. I would find that licensed producers are not allowed to have storefronts. So most licensed producers are guarding that license pretty heavily. Like, they wouldn't want to get involved in anything that's untoward. So that's what you find out with these guys. It's like, man, I got it. I made through all the hoops. I ain't losing this piece of paper. So
yeah.
The storefront operations are illegal. And the licensed producers, I would think, wouldn't engage in it. But then I've already seen advertising, and you're not supposed to do that. So
that too. Okay. So it's one of those things we'll have to wait and see, perhaps.
Yeah. I mean, it would be neat to see if Compassion Club operators, after all these years, can enter this market. That'd be great. Toronto's supposed to be cannabis friendly. But that said, they're not allowed to retail in the Health Canada Act. They're just not allowed to retail.
It's unfortunate. Yeah, exactly right.
What would happen if a Compassion Center stopped retailing and started mailing?
Well,
one good question I see in the chat room.
All right.
And maybe it goes back to some of your interviews with LPs and maybe some of the future ones. But did any of the LPs lobby to, like, get rid of personal grows?
Well, we asked Tweed, and I've asked Tweed. I remember asking Chuck. I was like, so did you... And Were you part of the discussions with Health Canada regarding the new program? And he's like, no, I was not. Same with Mark. They were both like, we weren't involved in that. Stakeholders meetings, I guess they were called, they weren't there. So none of those groups have lobbied. These guys, what you need to understand is they need to get stuff from Health Canada, i.e. they need to get more paperwork approved. Their focus is their business, is what I find. And so it comes to, we need to make sure that our narcotics production license, you know, they're working with us. They're not that interested in, like, the dispute between the access people and whatnot.
Clearly, though, even if most of them aren't interested, there might have been one or two parties out there that were. And if any of you guys in the chat room could find out and do some research...
Well, there's like, some, like, reliable sources.
No. Send us a link of the stakeholders meeting, and if there's anything that's public about it, let's find out.
There's no notes from that stakeholders meeting.
Well, I'm saying, if something out there exists, send us proof, and then I would love to attack any fucking commercial company that also advocated almost a monopoly or whatever, that you can't have your own personal grow either.
What do you think? Some of these. So what you're saying, if you went to a stakeholders meeting, you would oppose them.
I would oppose who?
I said, that's where do you... You went. If you went to a stakeholders meeting, is that where you... Because a lot of compassion clubs went to the stakeholders meeting.
Sure. I assume, like this... I heard in some of those tweets with CTV today that said the crowd of the courtroom was getting rambunctious at points. I assume that's what it would be like for people in our movement. When something gets brought up that's a red flag to us, we all kind of know. But these fucking hypocrite commercial companies that might also advocate that you can't grow personally, most of them, you were probably right by your original statement, most weren't even involved. The ones that were probably didn't have an interest in that way, one way or the other. But there's some that have an evil interest in making sure you don't have the right to grow yourself. I wonder. Anyways...
Well, so my go back to you. So what you're saying, if you went to the stakeholders meeting and you got an LP license later, you're evil?
Even like Mark from the 80s, if a bookstore...
Well, no. That's
yes, if a company advocated for monopoly and the same thing Health Canada did, which is they must destroy their product and they can't grow it themselves. If there was a company out there advocating it, I would just say let the free market reign on that individual and don't buy from them.
No.
But I would classify those actions as evil.
Huh. All right, so I guess you're opposed to a couple of Compassion Club owners then.
I probably am.
If they went to, I don't know. It's a silly argument.
Not necessarily.
Sure it is.
A lot of people try to get the upper hand in normally the free market by...
Yeah, they're called lobbyists, Chris. Happens every day.
But by...
Yes, it does. It happens every day.
But by
lobbyists
using the power of
government
to hurt your competitors?
Every day. Are you that naive? Next topic.
Okay.
Are you that naive about government lobbying? Take a course.
But not...
yes, they do, Chris. Yes, they do.
But when I go and buy my same, when I go and do
I'm
stuff,
not talking about that.
Thousands of businesses I deal with don't have a lobbyist that are trying to get rid of their competitors. And the ones that do are evil. We might not always know which ones those are, but that's not the
happens
distinction.
Happens every day, I guarantee it.
And some are just trying for.
In fact, wait, time
better
out.
Regulations.
Call the
in
920
their field.
And you can pull this up.
It is 920. I should have played some.
I got the answer to that. And we'll end the debate in a heartbeat.
Can't wait.
As I take hits from the ball. So it's 9:20.
No.
It's 4:20 somewhere. French Islands, I think.
I think so, French Islands.
Between Alaska and Hawaii. And it's been a good interview, a good 2 hours so far, and we're going to get back to the show.
All right, so I'm going to end that point on... Jack Daniels is lobbying the Tennessee government to insist that Tennessee whiskey be put to a recipe that just happens to be the recipe that Jack Daniels uses. So they are lobbying the Tennessee government to crack down on other companies that claim their whiskey is Tennessee whiskey because it doesn't follow the traditional method of making it.
But that's the same thing as the word champagne, I think, isn't it? It can only be called champagne.
No, that's regional pride. This is like...
It can only be called champagne. It's all just sparkling wine, but it can only be called champagne if
typical
it's...
Typical Gridwin, right?
No, I do
that.
Get the point.
You said competitors don't go and lobby government to hurt their competitors.
I didn't say that they don't. I said that they shouldn't, and it's an evil move in the way that our society works.
Well, there you go. Tennessee whiskey, Jack Daniels.
I also heard something about Tennessee.
When did you start being for how society works?
Supposedly, they lost the patent recently, so that's pissing them off.
That's why they're,
because they've been around for over 100 years, and for the first 50, they had it extended to 70, then they had extended to 90, and then extended to 100, but I think they lost their last extension or something.
That's why they're lobbying government in Tennessee to make sure that the label for the whiskey is their recipe. And their response is, no, people, like, don't know. Continue. What else you got, buddy?
Actually, that finished up the last questions that I had were about how to get the application filled out. So I think I've satisfied my viewers' curiosity with their answers there for sure. That's definitely a good start in getting towards the new LPs and getting on the new program.
What are you working on this summer?
Just my glass.
Just your glass,
my glass and my online presence. And
so people can buy your glass online?
Yeah, definitely. On Facebook is the easiest place to get a hold of me. It's MASTAH.ROLLA. Master Roller on YouTube. If you type in Master Roller, any spelling of it, you'll probably find me pretty quick.
So you will be making more YouTube videos?
Definitely. I keep up with a couple a week and, different tutorials on rolling, different ways of vaporizing different types of glass, for sure.
Got anything you want to talk about other than the glass new program?
I think the program was the main thing that I had in mind to discuss today.
Electroforming,
definitely look
cool,
forward
man.
To that. Currently, I'm only working with a very small electroforming system, and after how much fun I've been having with it, I think it's a no-brainer to invest in the more robust, larger unit so I can...
Can we get a life-size unit?
A life-size unit?
Can we, like...
You can't do yourself. That's how Egyptians died.
Can you, like, put me in there like Han Solo?
Yeah, I was about to say, you're thinking of, not Kryptonite, but... it just shows how much of a Star Wars fan I am, right?
That's Han Solo's when he got crash frozen.
Yeah,
can you do
definitely.
That?
I've been thinking about doing that on a smaller scale, for sure.
You'd have to make a mold.
Carbonite.
We do have a Star Wars fan in the
So you can carbonite
too.
Me?
I think that would be definitely a goal. However,
with
I don't...
With the electroform?
Would you do it naked?
Do it naked? See my junk there?
Electroform?
Preserve forever. I think that's how the Romans did it.
They felt
that that was very important. So.
It's how the Romans preserved their junk.
Electroform this.
I think they used stone, but either way.
I didn't know the Romans preserved their junk smash.
Fact.
So Bud Tender Sean just said John Conroy's case heard today with file number T203013 is being posted Friday with decision number whatever, and they give the link courts.gov.bc Supreme Court.
But it could be any time before Friday.
Here's an electroform piece that is one of the larger ones that I've actually done with the electroforming.
Cool.
And this one is Brady's.
That's really neat.
That one's really cool, eh?
Just a nice little mini tube.
Gidwin, can we electroform like one of your children?
I thought you were going to say smash.
Fucking electroform's cool.
Sometimes you electroform your kids' shoes.
Really?
I don't know if people have electroformed their kids.
Right, that's what they do when they have their first little walkie shoes. Yeah. And then parents like get those like, is that what they do?
Well, the electroforming process can be used with a lot of different metals. So I believe that you bronze your baby shoes.
Yep.
Oh.
But it would be the same process, definitely.
Smash, do you have bronze baby shoes?
No, my parents were poor.
I do.
I'm from the forest, no joke.
If your parents are baller, you have gold-plated baby shoes.
Kid, when you have gold-plated baby shoes?
No.
What about Aaron? Does Aaron have gold-plated booby shoes?
She has a sack of gold somewhere, I hear.
Electroforming. Fuck, we learn about new shit every day on this show.
It's amazing.
I know.
Stoners. Learning.
Learning. Carbonating. I mean, electroforming.
I think it's the same process.
Think so?
Same idea.
Looks like it, I think.
Yeah, we'll go with that.
Flow of electricity.
We'll go with that.
All right, well, I'm going to write that into my new will. Wish to be electroformed upon death.
You will be preserved forever. I think the Egyptians should have taken a note out of that book. It would have been a lot more effective than mummifying their pharaohs.
For sure. Well, it's good to see you, Master Rolla. Thanks for coming on.
No, it's been a pleasure, Matt. Always nice to see you, man. On the show.
We've got to come on. You got to make some videos of glass, and then we'll just show them on the show, and you can just come on and tell us.
Yeah, that'd be excellent.
Sounds like a plan.
All right, why don't we do that?
All right. Thanks, guys.
Next time he's on the show, Master Rolla. Jenny from Stoner Girls Guide couldn't make it in because her Crohn's was acting up.
Nah, fuck.
That's why I thought maybe your Crohn's was bad today, too. I'm like, oh,
Changer's
not here, Smash's not here, I feel like crap. Serious, like my hurt from head to toe. So much so that Emily beat the fuck out of me earlier today just by playfully tapping me. Oh, that doesn't hurt. Fuck, you have no idea. I'm fibroed from head to toe every shot.
You should have, like, a remote control that when that happens, you just push and, like, somehow a big boot comes out of nowhere and kicks the person away from you.
Yeah, I'd been good to kick out.
Or you should get a service dog that's, like, taught to jump on people and get them away from you.
Yeah, I could get a service dog for sure, and then they couldn't keep it out of here either. My service dog to prevent potheads from, like, playfully touching me. Well, I have a high fibro day. No playfully touching me, damn it. I'm going to feel tomorrow's show after the show tomorrow. But, yeah, my fibro, holy crap.
So I just opened the Skype lines.
And?
Well, nothing yet. I'm just saying I just opened them. So
2 hours into the show, you finally got around to opening the Skype?
Well, you guys were busy.
I would have taken Skype anytime.
And I wanted to make sure the show has been running smoothly and it has been for the last 2 hours without crashing. So I
good.
Hope.
Well, that's and we did
but
read
for
all
the first
her
10, 20 minutes of the show. It crashed 4 or 5 times. So I was trying to.
Yeah. And we did read all the tweets from CTV. It was like we were there, but not really. So we know that. Lots of questions.
If we need content, we could talk about the project you helped me with.
Yeah, next week on the show, we're going to start showing you health commercials filmed by Smash and I.
Can't wait.
I can't wait to show these. We should make a series of them. You can tell.
Hi, so I can do it. So.
Yeah, the first time I was giant cue card holder and the guy who made sure the camera looked good. And my first was like, 3, 2, 1, action. And she just fell over laughing.
It's just me giggling. Do you have all those like clips from me fucking up?
Oh, God.
So. And hilarious.
Then she blurted out, I can't do this. To which my response was like, I think we've done like 100 webcasts together. How can we not do a school project? I didn't know you could get a moldy apple that moldy.
It's been on the counter a while because I meant to juice that apple and I just didn't get around to juicing that apple.
Love the juicing. Anybody else here juice? Just juice?
Any juicers?
Dave's not here, man. I haven't been eating much today. Obviously, I'm not feeling well. I had a burger. That's been one of my meals. But I've also conclaimed to eat 2 peaches, 2 mangoes, half a cucumber, and 3 heads of cauliflower, you know, the full stalk.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Today?
Boom, yeah, all through the juicer.
That's incredible.
So even though I haven't been able to eat much today because my face feels like someone just, it was like George St. Pierre just like fucking hit me on the way to here.
You have all the nutrients from all that.
Yeah, so I'm good on nutrients and stuff because like my brain tumor hurts like a motherfucker today. It really, really hurts. Today's one of those days where I really, truly feel disabled. So Now, hopefully it feels better because tomorrow on the campaign trail, we're out canvassing.
Yeah, I hope you feel better by tomorrow.
But
rest up.
Speak of diversity, only 3 women out of 30 on the mayor's ballot to run for mayor. Olivia Chow, Karen Stinson, an 18-year-old girl. She's got my second vote. Well, wait, not ranked ballots. But yeah, I mean, I feel disabled. It's cutting into me. Like, hopefully, like, tomorrow at 9 o'clock, I have to be awake and at a photo shoot place in my best, like, mayor attire. And then in the afternoon, we're out canvassing. So we do try and spend stuff on the campaign trail every day. And again, someone's like, you're not very serious running for mayor if you're in Vice.com wishing someone gets butt cancer. I'm like, listen, as a mayor, some mayors you need to just respond to things that way.
Yeah, at least you responded to it. I mean, you noticed it and you had an opinion on it and you said
an opinion and a light, you know, like, you know, if the city was under flood alert, you want the mayor to make sure that you remember the city's on a motherfucking flood alert.
Yes.
City's on a mofo flood alert. We got the team out working hard. Everybody's pitching in, but the city's underwater. It's not looking good. We are fucked. Okay, honey, the mayor just said the city's underwater and we are fucked. We are getting out of here. Because you know that's the right answer. And that would be like, Mr. Mayor, we're in real deep shit here. And if you're privately, your staff are saying it's real bad, deep shit and stuff, you got to tell, you can't sugarcoat that as everything's under control. Now, we got a rubber dinghy. We're bailing out of here. You know, you got to, you know.
We're preserving ourselves.
Yeah. But with Vice.com, butt cancer comments are fair. If you read Vice.com and you're a daily reader of Vice.com, somebody wishing the man had butt cancer is totally.
It's not a new low.
Yeah, it's not a new low at all. Now, if I was in, like, the Globe and Mail saying it, that would be uncouth of me.
Yes.
In the Globe and Mail, I would just say it's a heinous act, it's disappointing. I would bring myself up to the Globe and Mail level. But if I can run myself through the gutter via Vice, I will any day of the week. That's all I got to say on that. You can't be serious. I know enough about different media sources to be able to distinguish when to use different things.
Right, it's like different languages, dialects.
Yeah. Oi. What happened to Danger tonight? I wish my phone worked. Feels like somebody hit me right here.
Well, he only really misses us for the projects.
Yeah.
And he's in his last semester, so.
Down to the wire. And we have hired him after he graduates.
Perfect.
Yeah, he's going to come in and work for us.
Excellent.
Man, it feels like someone Tony Danza'd me.
You just said that.
I just said that. Totally feels like someone gave me the Tony Danza.
Is that where you just like beat your head into the headboard?
No, that's when like you're like banging someone from behind and you hit them on the back of the head.
Oh, the donkey punch.
You donkey punch them and scream, "Who's the boss?"
That's a good one.
I just said, it feels like someone Tony Danza'd me.
Well, yeah. Say you are, and you're like, no, Tony Danza.
Say my name. Who's the boss? You know, you got to be aware of those things.
More awful sex tips from Matt next week.
Yeah, don't listen, you know.
Slap in the vagina.
I just said that, you know, I felt like the victim of the Tony Danza. I didn't say I felt like giving someone the Tony Danza.
Oh.
Well, follow the conversation. I was holding the back of my head, and I said, man, it feels
I am.
Like
it's just funnier if I didn't.
I know. It's a good bit. Man, it feels like someone Tony Danza'd me. Man, I totally feel like someone donkey punched me.
Well, that's unfortunate.
Man, if I'm not making any sense, I apologize, but we do try. Phone's going to do a bunch of stuff, messages and whatnot. Turned it back on.
Any Skype or, like, new videos? The cops do anything stupid this week?
Well. What? Oh, yeah, UK. I can now get to UK Cannabis Factory Bust of the Week and stuff.
And no bad cop, no donut.
Oh, yeah. All right. Bad cop. We talked about it for the first hour. That's the bad cop story of the week. The full show.
Just wasn't introduced as that. That's right. That's why
I'm trying to get people who are around. Those are the messages, so I'm trying to see if we can get a hold of Jason Wilcox. Can you take a Skype call, Goodwin?
Yeah, maybe.
All right, so we'll see what we can do. We put it out there. So we got, Stoner Girl guys aren't here, and that would have taken up a good chunk of our show, too, tonight.
Did she promise to come next week?
It's hard to get her to promise anything.
Ouch.
I'm kidding. Sick like the rest of us.
Yeah. I wish her well.
Me too. Shitty Health Canada news. Visited Health Canada. Our visited Peace Naturals. Conroy Quays. Oh, yeah. UK Cannabis Factory Bust of the Week. Please kick down door, confiscate cannabis plants, and leave friendly message asking homeowner to get in touch.
What the fuck?
Following the link now. Seriously, you can't make this shit up. If Goodwin was able to switch cameras, you would see the photo of the... See, that's what they left at the dude's door. Sorry you were not home. It says, unfortunately, you were not at home and have no cannabis left. That's what they wrote on their note. 72 cannabis plants. And then they sent it out via Twitter, right? They sent a photo out and the dude's address. It got 2,000 retweets and 875 favorites. Now, if I were you and it was just to grow and they left a note, sorry you weren't home. Oh, wait. Got a message from the Stoner Girl guys watching at home. I can talk about that in a second. So, I don't know. So if they send out this tweet and you just happen to be the dude.
Yeah.
I'd fucking flee.
I would too.
Why not?
For a lot of damages. That's so rude. Just like if people not thinking. Someone's address, someone's life, not your business.
Yeah, because usually people get ratted out by people. Stoner Girl guys just tweeted and said, talk about the lunch that... Yeah, because we went to lunch yesterday and we went shopping, picked up 2 new dress shirts.
Very nice.
Value Village, $7.99. Very good for me. I'm the small guy size. It works every time. Oh, and they
so went to lunch.
Yeah, so I'm getting more messages from the Stoner Girl guides. We went out to lunch. We went to the Starving Artist over on Lansdowne.
Neat.
Recommend it. They only serve fucking waffles in this place. I'm dead goddamn serious. They put bacon in waffles.
That sounds good.
That's the starter. My starter was like, they're like, do you just want that as your starter? You want something else? I'm like, of that, bacon waffles, and then I had salmon waffles. Like, lots of salmon.
That might be okay. Was it tasty?
Right to the last, like, I couldn't finish the last bite. It was just like, you know what? This is a little too much. Very tasty, but a little too much.
Too rich.
Too, like, salmon-y. Yeah.
Sounds like a good concept, though. A waffle house?
Yeah, Waffle House, right there on Lansdowne, just north of Bloor.
What other things could you get on waffles?
Oh, they had the full lineup of fruit and veg, and they had everything.
Neat.
I know.
It's like a crepe, but on waffles.
So I recommend that.
The Starving Artist. Yeah, we were there with the Stoner Girl Guide. Good times were had by all.
Perfect.
Then we went shopping. at the Value Village. From there.
You got two shirts?
Got two shirts.
What colors were they?
One's green. I got a new green to replace my old green shirt.
Yeah.
And the other is a the brown one I wore tonight.
Oh.
Very nice shirt.
Very nice.
So Stoner Girl is saying she is might be the weather change like I'm suffering from today. Christ.
So by the way,
fucking weather.
I just opened a new package in the mail, and it's kind of interesting.
What's that?
I don't know if I should show it all on camera or not, but at least cut to this. What do you think it is?
Oh.
So this is a cease and desist order from Zigzag. about 50 pages worth.
It's about time.
No, but it's actually, I've already read the first 20 pages. I was just over there reading it. And they confuse a whole bunch of things. They cite...
Where do they cite? They better not cite
they
me.
They cite the case of Perrier versus Fira Less Marketing Corporation Limited in 1983, wherein the defendant filled ordinary tap water into green bottles that were similar to Perrier and a label very similar to that used by the plaintiff Source Perrier S.A. was created with the spoof word and it was about a liberal Pierre A. It was about his father Justin Trudeau, I believe, in 1983.
I don't know, you'll have to look into
that's
it.
Ironic.
So that they say that if this is the same as that, which it's not. It would be like me buying Perrier bottles of water.
No, that assumes that you're selling the papers, like the product, under something that's very similar.
No, I don't know what you just said there exactly. But
well,
they're
we didn't fake make Zigzags. They're not a weird manufacturer.
No, you made your own product that was.
But those are
Zigzags.
They're authentic Zigzags that we just put our own package over.
No, I went and bought 10,000 packs of Zigzags and put bows around them all, basically.
Rex, someone just Skyped.
All right. I see how you're framing it.
But it did come in today.
Yep.
Which is interesting.
But not a biggie.
No, because I'm gonna fight that. But even still, whatever. I said if I got a cease and desist order that was reasonable, I would stop. And
it's
I haven't
50 pages.
What?
It's 50 pages.
It is 50 pages.
I wonder how they tracked it.
No, the rest of the 50 pages are just every trademark they own in regards to Zigzag. But see, that's where it gets bad because I'm not impersonating any of the other trademarks. I'm not like creating my own box, my own packaging, and then therefore filling it with my own papers. That's what throughout this document, that's all they keep saying, is that if Mr. Goodwin, I guess, or whatever, is...
I see. You think you have had to manufacture the papers and then put them into packaging that was identical.
Right, like this Pierre water, like Pierre A. They were just filling tap water into bottles because obviously it only cost them 10 cents to do that. They could get thousands of bottles somewhere and then print a label.
Anywho.
But to buy them all...
Just call the lawyer and see what he says.
Right. So I'm not... Whatever.
Just give Young a call. It might be something he'd have fun with.
I think
that's all they'll do. I said from the beginning that like
just
you'll
claim
probably
you're
just
an
cease and desist, and then that's
they,
it.
They start off the...
This doesn't scare you.
It's neat how their letterhead even has the Zigzag guy on it.
Yeah. Mm. Right in the front. It'd be fun if they slipped up and they put the Trudeau one there.
You should, like... Call up the media again and do another round.
So they go on to say, even though your use of our client's copyrighted works do make a political spoof of Mr. Justin Trudeau, these activities as outlined can hardly be characterized as fair and would constitute copyright infringement. But what they outline is the fact that they believe that I'm taking their design and then making my own and filling it with cheap paper.
Well, maybe they don't understand what you did fully. Maybe they don't know that you cut them.
Exactly. So once they're aware...
You'd think they would have bought a pack and investigated it properly.
Yeah.
Yeah, because if they look into it, it's like, no, in my opinion, it's the same thing as if you go into a store and they're selling Bic lighters in a case or something with a logo on it. You're still buying a legitimate Bic lighter. You're just paying extra for the case.
Right. I'm allowed to put Bic lighters in cases. I could spray paint Bic lighters if I wanted. There's nothing stopping me from doing that. Anyway. And even maybe with the logo Bic in it, but spoofed somehow.
I know. Good luck with that.
Yeah, we'll see. I do like how it does say stuff like, you know, that the Zigzag name has over the last, where is it? Has acquired over the last 20 years a significant reputation and goodwill and a valuable call.
Man, all you have to do is have like a couple guys swear an affidavit that they're the shittiest papers known to man. I will swear that affidavit for you.
I will too.
Awesome. Your Honor, these are the shittiest papers known to man. Their first statement. These are 20 years of making our brand. Fuck. Your papers are poisonous when you light them. Who fucking knows what's in them? Like,
you should argue that you brought a lot of attention to their company.
Right.
A lot of people bought Zigzag rolling papers who I know for a fact will never once break out those papers.
Yeah, they're putting them all away.
Yeah.
Supposedly.
They've gone back to using their hemp brand, Your Honor.
Right.
Affidavit of Myrna.
Well, we'll see if it gets that far.
The shittiest rolling papers known to man, sir. I apologize for using the language. It's not advice.
Yes, so. But
ultra thin zigzag.
No. Buy a pack of the hemp papers, man. Buy something good. The zigzags, it's just something about, they're just... The paper's it's not.
Now you're gonna sue us for slander.
Tastes like shit in the back. They're just not.
So who wants to buy a pack of zigzags after I've gotten the cease and desist?
There you go. Last couple boxes now.
Yep.
Last couple boxes now. And at least one round of making fun of them.
Should make stickers of the cease and desist and slap them on the front as you sell them.
Could do that. Well, anywho, no, it took them like a little bit of research there. Like I said, you know, we can do another round of media where it's like zigzag with the cease and desist. You ride that last media wave out and you're good. You just like, you just tell them, yes, I'm ceasing and desisting. And by the way, I've sent this out as a media press release. You will get more media press release making them look like they're beating up a small little guy. And people, all the, you know. Just remember, not a fan of their rolling papers.
Do you think the second cease and desist would be a lot shorter?
Meh.
I'm not going to take my time.
I didn't know they tried to spoof his father, though, with Perrier water.
Which is really funny and ironic.
Look into the case law.
I'm going to have to. Filling up fucking tap water, though, that was obviously infringement.
I don't know. You have to look at the case law, Chris. I think, as I say, I would just claim artist and satire.
Interested what the lawyer will say.
Tell them you're going to defend yourself because they have to pay for their lawyers. Just as long as you don't lose court costs, then you're fucked. Just like how they tried to hit me at the Supreme Court of Canada for my appeal. And we want them to pay.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
That's awful.
Oh, but when it was their appeal, I had to pay. I had to pay my legal team. I know. And as soon as they told me, they're like, is there like Latin phrase on this notice? I'm like, yeah, that. You're like, oh. I'm like, what does that mean I have to pay? And the guy's like, yeah. I'm like, fuckers.
Shitty when they just go straight to the Latin.
Yeah, that's how you know you're getting fucked in law, when they speak it in Latin. Latin is legalese for you're getting fucked hard.
Yeah. Exact translation.
So next week on the show, Chris Goodwin reports back on Zigzag cease and desist. Get your papers now before we stop making them, I guess.
You could frame it and put it on the wall here.
Oh, yeah, we'll have that. We'll send out a... press, I don't know. Maybe I'll write something for Vice. Zigzag.
Like a follow-up article?
Yeah, follow-up article.
Craziness. That's okay. Ride it while you can. We got some fame out of that. Wonder how they tracked you down, Goodwin. One guy, the lawyer probably billed already 40 hours for reading all the articles on it.
Well, like we said, yeah, they didn't even purchase a package of papers because in the documents they have the photoshopped image that Chris created online before we even manufactured the papers. So they must be looking at it all from an online.
Yeah, they probably saw it in the media, Googled it, got angry, and then collected themselves.
Well, they have lawyers, right? So they got to have. Justify their existence somehow. Justifying my existence over here.
Bureaucratic masturbation.
Essentially. I'm worth hundreds of dollars an hour.
Give me work.
Reading cannabis culture and looking at Google photos of Justin Trudeau as a zigzag man. Anyways, we know what rolling papers we won't be rolling all those joints with this year at 420. Dicks. Bunch of fucking dicks.
We just put up lines that says no zigzags allowed.
Yeah, that at 420 you will not be able to bring zigzags if they continue with the harassment of our art.
If we see them, we will slap them out of your hands.
Yeah. Actually, we'll just collect them in a big waste paper basket.
And replace them with better papers as we go?
Nah, we can replace them with better papers. See, this is where companies got to look at their corporate image from a couple different angles. We could go down there and fuck our only market and here's the best thing. Someone should testify that they only use their zigzags for marijuana. Thereby fucking them forever. It's paraphernalia. I only use my zigzags for marijuana.
Lose their business in a span of a week.
Yeah, and it's... Can that's paraphernalia. I don't know many people who roll their own tobacco, really. Seriously, Zigzag, who do you think your market is? Really. I'm surprised they didn't get upset that you associated them with pot.
Yeah, that's a weird... Yeah, that's a very weird point that they didn't mention that.
Just send them back a letter that you're going to have people testify that their product is bad. And you got one guy for sure that says he enjoys their product for his marijuana. It's tell him you got 50 witnesses.
I'm sure legally speaking, they had to send one, a cease and desist order. I said it from day one.
Meh.
They probably, because I'm also ripping off Justin Trudeau's logo and stuff too, so they can't endorse it.
Sure they can. You just look the other way, Chris. That's what you don't realize.
They could
have.
It
can't be ambivalent, I guess.
But they spent the money and their lawyer...
No, they didn't spend anything. They have a lawyer on staff who has to justify his existence and he got around to it.
Ah, well, that's that.
Yeah, that's exactly that.
This is coming from an Ottawa lawyer, though, and these guys are in France, so there's a bit of a delay there.
What?
No, they would have counsel.
Anyways, I think it's cool. Frame it, put it on the wall.
Yeah, frame it, put it on the wall.
I'm going to have to take a few quotes from it and send it to the media, yeah.
Yeah, send it to the media and just as they say.
It does say something about they think Justin Trudeau might hurt their image. I thought that was funny, too.
I think it's funny that, as I say, it's associated with pot. I only use my zigzags for marijuana. Doesn't that make them paraphernalia?
Absolutely.
There you go. You should just tell them the lawyer. Call him up. He's like, I got a guy who's going to testify they only use it for marijuana.
Maybe they had a really hard time in the first Trudeau case, and now it's just a thorn in the ass that they have to deal with the Trudeau family again.
Maybe. I don't know.
What year was the first one?
83, but
that was
complete.
Perrier water.
Yeah.
Not zigzags.
Yeah. Still the Trudeau family, yeah?
There you go. It could be something completely different, though.
The conservatives were trying to do attack ads against Pierre Trudeau with water?
How do you know?
I don't know.
You haven't even read the case. It could
be something
completely different. Might not have anything to do with Trudeau. I'm just jumping. It's weird.
No, I think the Pierre is Pierre Trudeau.
What's the case? I'm going to look it up.
Okay, one sec.
Yeah, Perrier.
Pull it up in Canley.
It's Perrier to Pierre, wasn't it?
Right.
Right.
I don't know if Canley goes that far back, but when in doubt, check the legal archive, English.
Type source, Perrier S.A. versus Fira Less Marketing Company Limited.
Spell it.
Source, S-O-U-R-S-C-E, P-E-R-R-I-E-R.
Source, S-O-U-R, okay.
C-E.
Source, Pierre, right?
P-E-R-R-I-E-R-S-A, and then S-A versus Fira Less, F-I-R-A, dash L-E-S-S, Marketing Company Limited, 1983.
No.
It's like this. You should type like this.
We'd have to look it up by case law. Yeah, get back to me on the case law on that.
Just pull it up on the screen, too.
Oh, the stoner girls are... I think it's like, you know, she shouldn't have ate. See, we went to the Waffle House, stoner girl guy, and I was like, be careful, you might not want to eat that. And she's like, I think I'm okay. Now, today she might be sick or not.
Yeah. Poor thing.
Yeah.
Wish her well.
We do. Tracy Curley's also sick from the Opus show.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Cold? Or?
So... Yeah. So we wish her the best. She's in the hospital. She got home from the hospital today.
Oh, wow. Hope she's better.
I hope she gets better. She's got a... She has a... Losing her... She's had some foot issues, and she's a diabetic. So feet issues with diabetics are bad.
Yeah.
So we hope that she'll be back next week on the Opus show. Man, we wish her the best. I got a cold, and I got fibro day today. It's freaking hurts.
Double hit.
Yeah, double hit. And all the guests we tried to line up. You, Master Roll is here. Stoner Girls Guides, not so much. We'll try and get more people next week.
Yep.
Jason Wilcox isn't around, I hear. I got via texting. But we covered that Health Canada County pretty good. Next week, I don't know. We're getting close to 420. Oops, sorry, I got the cold. We're getting real close to 420.
Everything should take form soon.
Yeah. Spring this week. How many people know we hit the spring equinox? Was it Thursday or Friday? Spring equinox.
Either one.
Thursday? Through the...
Yeah.
The magnifying glass, and you're trying to get it to be a real fine beam. Not a big fat beam, but a fine
beam. I just tried to take a Skype call, and it crashed the show for the last 30 seconds. So.
Okay, no Skype calling. Sorry, guys.
Oh, wow.
Oh, I'm dying up here. Last 20 minutes. As I said, feels like someone Tony Danza'd me.
George St. Pierre'd you.
I'm just telling the truth up here.
I know. It's awful. I'm sorry.
Well, what do you got going on other than the school project that we worked on? Is it done? Like next? I thought it was due today.
It is due today, and I presented it today to the class.
And?
They all really liked it, actually.
Really?
Yeah. And one girl's like, I really like your sense of humor. It's actually a really weird video.
It is. When you see this video... You can see why Smash works on the Marijuana Zone. It's
really
the Refrigerator Humane Society.
Yeah, well, I had to teach students food safety. I had to build a campaign that could teach students food safety. So this is like a commercial that I had to make, and it's a minute long. And
yeah, so think student-run commercial for food safety. Yeah, we were good.
Yes, thank you very much for helping with that.
Not like nothing like spending a Sunday morning helping your buddy.
I did well.
Oh, that's good then. Make a video. We had a good night. Yep. met with the campaign team. What upcoming? So Wednesday canvassing photo shoot. Thursday last class of mindful meditation for me.
Oh yeah.
Yep.
Did you really learn something valuable from the weeks that you've gone? Right.
Yeah, I learned quite a bit from the mindful meditation. I recommend it to people. I do recommend it. It's a good program.
Excellent.
So that's Bridgepoint Health mindful meditation class. Get a referral from your doctor.
Do you want to talk about the different types that you learned? Walking, eating.
Yeah, I learned the mindful walking meditation. That was good for me. I've always been doing that kind of wrong. So mindful walking where you try and walk each step in the moment, like you like realize what you're putting your foot down and
move through it.
Yeah, you just live with it. So you try and take in your surroundings as if it's new to you for the first time. Excuse me. So that's like how mindful walking works. Mindful eating, of course, is recognizing the different flavors, the different textures.
Sounds excellent.
The time. Full body scan, which is where you check in with each little like body part.
Neat.
Yeah, so you're like,
super conscious.
Yeah, bottom of my feet. How are you doing? Oh, you really hurt today. I didn't really want to check in there. Or, you know, legs, how are you, you know. So that type of stuff is cool.
Very neat.
But it's something I'll use in daily life. I use it for video game playing.
Oh, yeah. How do you do that?
Mindful video game playing is freaking the best. I highly recommend mindful video game playing to everyone out there. It's about playing your video game in the moment. So, like, if you're playing Grand Theft Auto, for instance, think like your guy. Think like a gangster. Think like, you know... And you got to live in that moment of like, yeah.
Be really in the moment when you're murdering a hooker for money?
Yes.
Excellent.
I'm also very in the moment when I play video game baseball, Major League MLB 13. I'm amazing. My career is epic right now. And, of course, when I'm out there playing Skyrim, Elder Scrolls, man. Lord Eldric the Vampire... Fuck, man, like level 40, I just like sneak in the shadows and blow people away with my, like, I'm like right in the moment when I'm pulling that arrow. I'm like, yeah, Lord Eldric's gonna kill you. Like, just guys falling, and oh, he's so good, Lord Eldric. Level 42 vampire in Elder Scrolls.
Yeah.
I am slot, you know, just like.
Yeah.
Like, I had a frost dragon.
Did you?
The frost dragon, living in the moment, I knew enough, like, hey, I can withstand frost, not fire, because I'm a fucking vampire. And the frost dragon just, like, hit me with the full-on frost, and my guy, Lord Eldric, I was like, yeah, bitch, I'm in the moment, because I thought, can't do anything to me.
When you play those games, can you really feel that you're the only person that slept with a woman?
No.
No. I'm just kidding.
No, not at all. Surprisingly enough, video games do have a pain release outlet. I know. People who play a lot. One of the first things I saw was it happened in World of Warcraft. A lot of people who could spend a lot of time on World of Warcraft were, of course, the pained. So, I think there's a strong correlation between pain and video game playing for some people.
Just escaping?
Yeah, it's definitely escaping. If you can escape your pain by pretending you're Lord Eldric in the Skyrim universe.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Right? There's something to be said about that. In fact, when I do play video games, one of the ones I'm looking for right now is Civilization Rebellion for the PS3.
Fuck. What's that about?
Well, it's about running... an empire. Like, so if you're Abraham Lincoln, you would set up the state of, like, the city of Washington, San Francisco, New York City. Like, if you were, like, Stalin, you would set up Moscow. And
oh, okay.
You'd start in 6000 BC, and you'd just run through until the space age.
Oh, neat.
Yeah. Now, I can dominate that game on my DS, so I was like, oh, that just kills so many hours. And just to put it in perspective, I have like 275 hours in Elder Scrolls, by the way.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. That's 10 days of my life. Not necessarily gone, but dedicated to a video, like, you know, something different than what I usually do. I think people should be aware of that.
That's a good project, 10 hours.
10 days.
10 days, sorry.
But then it's also probably the only one I played for like a year. Mostly. So I think people, you know, should look at video games and think about that when they're out there. I think video games and getting high, you know, definitely. Who doesn't like hanging around their buddies and smoking a couple joints, playing some video games? Fucking right.
It is a good time. Yeah. LAN party, yeah.
LAN party. You know. I don't like the Call of Duty shit, though. It's all that shooty. It just gets to me. I don't know.
Do you get dreams of murdering people?
No, it wrecks my high. It's just there to get high. It's here to get high. I was doing, for Geek Chic Elite, we were doing Grand Theft Auto Online reports where I would play online, not with my friends, but just play the game mm-hmm. and see what random encounters I could get into. And then it just sort of got, like, getting, like, spawned into universes of, like, guys just bitching about who had better weed.
And they're just like, I do, LOL, and you leave.
Yeah, essentially. I'm like, actually, my response on the headset when they bitch about weed, I'm like, fuck, bitches. Why don't you just take this argument to Vapor Central? I came here to play some Grand Theft motherfucking Auto. Like, let's get in some cars and race around and shit. Like,
excellent.
What the fuck? My weed's better. My Girl Scouts is the pimp. Bro, you got shitty weed, admit it, and you're playing Grand Theft Auto, smoking pot. Just enjoy yourself.
Yeah, exactly.
Fuck. You know, there's like this kid who's online and you're like, are you 14? And it's like, yes. I'm like, does your mom know you play this game? Like, and one was like 12.
Wow.
I'm like, there's a 12-year-old trying to tell me how to play Grand Theft Auto. I'm just like, I'm like going to be in my head, you're an internet lure. You're like evil. Hey, does your mom know you play this game? Like, fuck, parents.
Wow.
Pay attention a bit.
They would have had to buy it. Doesn't it come with like the warning label on it?
M. It comes with M, yeah. They'd have to buy it. It's best. My favorite is when the guy who kills me online and his child is screaming from neglect online. I'm like, nice shot, asshole. Can you please get your screaming kid to shut up?
Wow.
Like, your whole... Yeah, I'm the worst at trash-talking any video game guy. I'm like, your parenting skills are as terrible compared to your shooting skills. Like, spend some time, buddy.
Punching people in their, like, parenting skills?
Fuck yeah.
That's awful.
Yeah, nothing like saying, nice shot, buddy. It's too bad your parenting skills weren't the same. Can you get your kid from shutting up? Nobody wants to go online and play online video games with some guy's background headset with their kids screaming.
You could just regenerate it somewhere else.
I do a lot. I respawn everywhere. Especially, you know, the way I play, people come at me.
You're a menace.
I try to be a menace. Like the guy who brings in the tank in the game, I'm like, dude, I got two tanks too. Like, big fucking deal. Game's not meant to be played that way.
You'd make a great dictator.
Probably not. But yeah, you know, in some context, sure.
It's joking.
For negotiations, obviously. You know, I'm like Billy Bean when it comes to negotiations. Baseball season's almost back. March 31st, opening day. I'm ready.
You send them your resume?
Not yet. I'm waiting for the fall. If the mayor thing doesn't work out, I want to go to, like, Phoenix, Arizona, have scout school for 12 days.
Oh, wow. That's awesome.
It's a professional baseball-level scouting school. but you have to be sponsored by a major league team.
Oh.
So my goal is, like, once this mayor thing, if it doesn't pan out, I'll contact Alex Anthopoulos of the Toronto Blue Jays and be like, man, here's my story. Here's what I can do. I'm smart.
Sponsor.
Like, sponsor me. I'm smart. I can do this. Just like I go to Google. Like, you could hire me because I'm smart, or you could hire me because I'm smart and I use medical marijuana. They'd have to build a whole team around me because I'm disabled.
And the whole Google atmosphere.
The Google atmosphere would change if I was there. We got a weed guy in that wing. Do you imagine, like, I'd have, like, my own doors that were, like, vacuum sealed and stuff.
Two layers?
Yeah, but because they would want to make me feel inclusive, not excluded, right? People would, like, it'd be like a glass sort of, like...
Yeah.
So I could wave
glass
to people.
Like fishbowl.
Yeah.
One that you can smoke in, though, and no one else is affected.
Yeah, and then people could be, like, come into my office when they need to or something. I could leave my space when
they want to.
When I need to.
Yeah.
The Google would be the best place for me to work. They have a chef. They could afford to build vacuum-sealed doors. That go whoosh. Do it have the Star Trek noise and stuff?
Maybe you have a couch so you can invite your friends.
Well, my friends from Google. Hey, guys, let's do a work.
He's going to be elitist.
I can't invite people over to my work office.
I only talk to Google people.
Well, see, that's different than working with the mayor. I can invite, you know, he invited his friend Tamara over to his office. Well, the office of the mayor is open to the public, so I'm like, oh, well, my friend Tamara just, you know, stopping by for a sesh.
Oh, neat. That sounds fun.
That's the plan. I mean, you got to, like, I plan on bringing a PS4 and a flat screen.
Perfect.
Out of my own salary, by the way, I buy that PS4 for the mayor's office.
For what, like the waiting lobby?
No, for myself.
Oh, for yourself.
You know, there's nothing like after a long meeting to going off and just fucking playing a video game for an hour. It's like, you know, like a lot of marketing offices do that. We got the Wii U down at Pixel Dream, so... And people are like, what, you wouldn't get a PS3 or an Xbox 360 or you'd move up to the PS4 or the Xbox One? I'm like, listen, if I bought the PS3... and brought it to the mayor's office in a new box, everybody would freak that I didn't get the PS4.
Maybe.
Can't win.
You might just think that it's really cool.
Yeah, on my own salary, I would put a flat screen in there and a PS4 so that after long meetings, to unwind our minds, you know. Yeah. Do you imagine the chief coming by and be like, after a meeting with him? Like, hey, you want to play some Duck Hunt?
That'd be so fun.
So it was a pretty intense meeting with the chief and I, but then he broke out. You know, the chief's like, it was a pretty productive meeting, and then he asked me to play a little bit of Duck Hunt. Thought the chief be really good at shooting birds and stuff.
And then you were...
Or big game hunter. And just be like, yeah,
moose.
It's worked in... Yeah. It's worked into your calendar, sir. After our meeting's only going to go 45 minutes, but we're going to play 15 minutes of video games afterwards. You have to play Big Game Hunter with me. That's how your team can bond, even on stress negotiations and tight stuff. At the end of it, just be like, hey.
Get it all out in the video game and work everything out and have something in common.
Yeah. That's what I liked about Peace Naturals is they have one of the growers plays video games. It's like, you got to check out the new South Park game. It's really awesome. Blah, 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 blah.
Neat.
And the other guy's like, oh, baseball. My family and I used to go to all the stadiums. I'm like, my family and I used to go to all the stadiums, too. For road
Neat.
Trips.
It's iconic.
Yeah, so things that you try and bond with people in different ways than just cannabis. No. So issue the memo to staff because they probably, you know. People always hit me in my left shoulder. Please note, it's my gimpy arm.
Just don't hit Matt.
Fuck. It's really hurting tonight. More so than ever. It's just miserable. So we got that. Thanks everybody for tuning in tonight. It's spectacular show. We were able to read the tweets, so it's like we were in the courtroom.
Yeah, that was really good coverage.
We said our piece about Health Canada. We got Operation Mailout going on. That means, like, send letters to Health Canada and send them in mass to the rat snitch line.
Yeah.
If everybody did one book of like, 10 stamps, we'd
bought
get
them
somewhere.
Forever.
You know. So we're going to work on that. So we got that. Next week again, I promise, I hope not to be ill. But it happens.
We always hope that anyways.
Heck, if I didn't work at one day a week, I wouldn't be here. I'm like, it's like when you feel so bad, you're just like, you know what, I only work one day a week.
You have to go.
And the final joke was the potheads of Don't people were asking how are you feeling tonight, because you know you're sore. I'm like, I looked at Naomi and I'm like, I feel like Naomi.
Wow.
Naomi's got pretty banged up, by the way. She's 65.
She's looking rough.
And she's got fibro pretty bad. She's having a rough day too. Mm. So. All you in chronic pain land, we thank you guys for tuning in. We appreciate that. All our pain friends.
Stay high.
Stay high the best you can. You know, just do the best you can is what we're trying to get at. And if it's listening to the show, you can download us on iTunes or SoundCloud. Appreciate that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Always great fun on the show. Bud Swap was amazing.
Bud Swap was great this week.
Yeah.
It worked at a really good pace. I'd like it to pace out like that more often.
Thanks for the show, Myrna.
I'm a tortured man. trade half my money for 10 times as much sex? It's an equation from hell.
Oh, that's
it's an equation from hell.
Oh,
it's an equation from hell.
Oh, that's
it's an equation from hell.
Oh.